People deluded, I'm back again. Hey, you lot always get onto me and say I don't smile when we can't count our chickens just yet. We're still waiting on official confirmation, but Thomas Partey looks as good as done. The club seem to have not only hoodwinked me, but hoodwinked the whole of the footballing fan base into believing it wouldn't be done. I'm happy, people, and I can see everybody else is ecstatic as well, man. You can see it, but let's pre-order comments quick, man. It's the most I've seen you lot jumpy before a live stream. Come on, man. I'm seeing a lot of positive comments. Come on. Exactly what Planet X says, man. I can't sleep either. Obviously, the time difference and you, my guy, because you're in Australia, is different. Hey, man. Trust me, I'm smiling, my guy, boy. I'm smiling, but I'm excited still because I've been on the case of signing a midfielder. We need a midfielder, we need a midfielder, we need a midfielder. Nothing can get done without a midfielder. And I believe that for two reasons. I feel, you know, you either defend from the front, you dominate possession and you put the opposition under sustained pressure, or you look solid defensively. While I believe in Arteta and he's training us and all of these sort of things, I don't believe we're able to do either or consistently yet. So I do think you need specialists, and that's what Partey is. You know, Partey, in terms of athleticism, he can get up and down the field. Let's listen, and that's what I want to focus on. But he can pass the ball forward. The man can play ball. I'm not looking at him to be the creative engine of such. I still would like another midfielder in, but just to see one is ecstatic, people. My guy, I can't lie to you. Like I said, we can't count our chickens just yet. But listen, AFC Bell for like 6 months has been onto that Partey thing. I almost lost faith, and he's been proven right. You know, if Arsenal do announce Partey, they need that AFC Bell Twitter account guy in the announcement video. He's been solid on this, and he's come through. And the minute he said it's happening today, I can't lie, I saw the major stations jumping on it. You've had the Ornsteins and the etceteras, etcetera. You know, I'm happy if we do bring in Partey because he gives us a midfielder. If we can't bring in a creative man, then we're going to have to play around with our options. I don't know if Arteta's tempted to play Willian in that 10 role, give Emile Smith-Rowe a chance, persist with Reece Nelson or Joe Willock, potentially, because Nelson can play in that role, or what? First priority would be, or bring back Ozil. My first priority, people, is actually to bring in a specialist, you know? So I'm happy for Partey. It gives us a composing figure. The problem is, it's the same way I was gassed about Gabriel, people. You know, we can't look at one man coming into this team to change it all. Listen, Partey takes us up another level. I'm not saying don't be excited, but don't expect him by himself to be the difference maker. In the same way we looked at Ozil when he came to, you know, to make the difference by himself. We need a collective squad, man. So, yeah, I don't even get that comment. But, yeah, people, I'm happy. But, listen, let me not let my excitement pull you away from actual facts, people, the actual cold-hearted facts in relation to Partey, which you lot are known to like of me. Now, there's a lot of, you know, if you type in his name, there's a lot of different stations and whatnot speaking about it and whatnot. But it is what it is. On goal.com, Charles Watts, which in my first video in relation to Partey was the first bit of information I saw, he said himself via goal.com, who I assume he works for, Arsenal have made a late move to sign Thomas Partey from Atletico Madrid before tonight's transfer deadline. Goal has learned the Ghana international, who has a release clause of 50 million euros, has been a priority target for the Gunners all summer. Discussions with Atletico have taken place during the past months, with Arsenal hoping to land the midfielder for a fee less than his release clause. But Atletico have consistently stated the only way Partey will be leaving this summer is if that clause is activated. Now, there's a lot of people following on from it and people and whatnot. And what can I say? First and foremost, I'm happy. Second of all, what does that love for the comment, my guy? What does that tell you? That tells you, in hindsight, you know, Arsenal were playing on the "we're broke" sort of stuff in the summer, and we were trying to haggle, and we clearly have tried to play a game of poker, waiting for the other team to move, which is Atletico, who have the player, so they have the position of strength to play chicken, and it ain't worked for us. So we've come to the conclusion that, you know, the only way we can actually sign my man is if we pay the money, put the money on paper and give it to them. And some other reports have said, you know, we don't actually need to further negotiate with Atletico. I mean, of course, to a degree we do, but I assume once we've made a statement of our intent to activate his release clause, There's no further bargaining to do with Atletico. It's firmly talking to Thomas Partey and his representatives, which you hear our legal team, as expected. I love for that Life Planet X. You threw me off there, though. As expected, our legal team would be at the training ground as they dot I's and cross T's. Apparently, they're there. You know, we've activated the release clause. It's firmly a case of agreeing what we need to agree with Partey. His medical will be taking place in Spain. Obviously, I actually watched his, in hindsight, this, I'm sure that's his last game. You know, I watched Villarreal versus Atletico. And, you know, Unai Emery was the Villarreal manager. It seems he has been wanting to move. I hear there's a lot of stuff in relation to his contract, but I'm happy that we're getting our man. Do I think it's happening? I do think it's happening purely because of AFC Bell. He's been onto this for time and whatnot. I'm happy for him because he gives us a bit of athleticism. Ironically, I would have liked to have kept Herrera within the side and used the either-or approach or use both of them. But it takes us up another level, you know. For me, do you now go Xhaka, Partey and maybe play Ceballos in a further forward role? Especially if we can't sign this midfielder, you know, the creative sort of guy. You know, do you play Partey and Ceballos and get rid of Xhaka, or Xhaka has to fight for his spot? I say get rid. Obviously, Xhaka's a good player and a key part of the team. There's competition for places now, people. And I really like the signing of Partey. You know, Partey, Gabriel, while, you know, ideally you would like a suitable partner for Gabriel if Saliba's not going to play this year of the same standard, and Partey you'd like an equally levels midfielder. It's a step in the direction. It's a sort of way to improving the spine of this club, which, you know, our spine is the big part going into the season. We know we needed to sign a midfielder because our spine isn't good enough. I was concerned. I thought we'd bring a midfielder in. I'm not going to say Partey purely of the basis you hear Torreira's going out on loan. If anybody didn't know already, Matteo Guendouzi is about to confirm his loan move to Hertha Berlin. So we're down to our bare options. For me, it's just, I would have liked to have kept Torreira, but he's a different one just to have that in the squad. Because, you know, Partey is just no man's an island. Partey's alone, really. You know, you've got Partey, Ceballos, who's had a resurgence. I think Xhaka will prove his worth as he has been very consistent. But again, you know, for me, Xhaka is a squad player. Elneny has shown when called upon, he can do a thing. But again, you're not looking at him to be the difference. I don't think, you know, it's the best of summers. Clearly, there's a lot of outgoings we need to do. And hopefully there's some outgoings. You've heard, you know, Kolasinac linked with Leverkusen. Mustafi's apparently got interest from Italy in a permanent and a loan basis. You're hearing the same about, if I haven't said it, Sokratis. So we will see a lot of outgoings. If I haven't said it or made it clear already, Guendouzi is apparently going to Hertha Berlin. I don't mind him going for Hertha Berlin. You know, ideally, him playing, excelling out there, it increases the market value we could potentially get next season for him to see what we can do next year. Who knows, maybe a year out there, he might have underappreciated the position he has at Arsenal and he might pattern up and come back and be a better player. Obviously, for Guendouzi, he needs to play games. I know Arteta was very diplomatic in all the press conferences and said all the, everyone's earned a spot and whatnot. But, yeah, he don't want him for whatever reason, you know, purely the Brighton thing. I think Arteta did believe in him, but disciplinary issues, you know, Arteta has to stamp his authority and Guendouzi crossed the line, so he's gone. You know, obviously he wants to try and play for France. He's very unlikely, in my opinion, to go to the Euros, but if you're not playing, you don't have a chance. There's also the Olympics, if due to COVID, that ain't been put off. So I understand the move and Torreira's move, it makes sense. And again, there still might be a way of Atletico actually messing that up because apparently they need to move a player on. You'd like to imagine, if we're realistic, they wouldn't have made Torreira go through all the trouble of completing a medical if they weren't confident of removing a player. And ironically, Partey might actually be the one out, one in sort of thing. When Partey's thing is concerned, probably in the same breath that you'll see Torreira depart. And again, I'm not going to harp on about Torreira, but just in terms of having another combative figure, that would have been nice. For me, you know, Partey's best as a box-to-box. He can win a ball back, so there's no need for a defensive mid. I'm keen to see what we do with the formations, though, because we could play a 4-2-3-1. Like Kyle Gordon said, you know, we could play a 4-3-3. You know, I wouldn't mind that at all, to be fair. I agree what you mean. We need a proper 10. I want a modern-day sort of midfielder, my guy, someone that's able to create but isn't necessarily, you know, the poetry in motion and the Ozils, I know James is doing dirt, but James did, and all of these sort of players, I think we need a mod. I'm not, James is different because he's doing his thing, but I think we need a more modern day creative midfielder. We need to get rid of the poetry emotion stuff. Thank you very much for your words, man. But I'm gassed for Partey, people. Again, we still got to wait for official confirmation. We still got to wait for a lot of things to be done. There's still a long couple of hurdles to go down. Probably doing his medical. But again, you'd imagine that all parties concerning Partey, you know, We wouldn't have left it down to the last day if there was anything can happen, especially anything can happen as a football fan. But we wouldn't have left it to the last day if there wasn't some real genuine confidence that this deal wouldn't get done, whether we delayed it because we wanted to, you know, get a cheaper salary or what. But we must have had an agreement in place with Partey and his advisors for a period of time now. And we told them it would get done, sort of thing. So is what it is. My next concern, my people, is, you know, that's one part of the jigsaw. Again, Partey is brought in to be a difference maker, and I'm looking at him to do that. But no man is an island. He can't take it to the next level by himself. And like I said, while I think Partey has a lot of quality, not only driving with the ball and getting the ball further forward, also passing, I'm not looking at him to be the creative hub. I'm looking at when the opportunity arises to him doing it, we need a next man for that. And I'm not sure if we're going to get that. So maybe we have to concede that at least for this season, we have to play with a Willian, maybe integrate Fingy back into the squad, Ozil, and do a couple of these sort of things. I think I speak for every Arsenal fan or just fan that on a non-biased thing looks at Arsenal when I say that there's not really an outstanding choice in terms of creativity. For me, I'm probably leaning towards something that incorporates Partey, Ceballos, and if he wants to play Xhaka, that's fine. I don't think he's a defensive mid. Sorry, I think he's a box to box guy, but he can put a foot in. We need more than that, exactly like he said. But I think people underestimate Partey's quality on the ball. You know, he's got a lot of quality on the ball, and he showed that against who did he play? Not Villarreal. It was a game that stands out. I can't even remember it. I'll remember it by the end of this stream. But yeah, man, it's a good look. For me, the only thing is it's dangerous playing poker, you know, with another team, because it could go a different way. You know, it seems like we've had a free hit to a degree for Partey. There might have been interest from elsewhere. But, you know, imagine the next team come and complicate things. Imagine Chelsea or someone else comes in, because, you know, Chelsea are looking for that composing figure. Him and Declan Rice are two separate players, but he can play as a defensive mid, even though I think he's best in a box-to-box ball winning sort of, you know, sort of getting up the field, winning the ball sort of thing. The next step, like I said, is a more creative midfielder, which hope we have small resurgence. You know, you never know. You know, I'm a bit gas, people. I'm hoping that we can go back for our, but the romantic in me is believing that story isn't done. But the man's come out himself. He said he's not leaving and whatnot. So we're probably having to scratch and whatnot. And it's going to be not just for Arsenal. It's an interesting couple few hours, you know, because Eriksen's apparently been offered to Premier League teams, you know. Depending on the fee and depending on the loan, maybe that's an option. You know, Thomas Lamar, you know, the namesake and former teammate, or soon to be former teammate of Partey, previously linked with Arsenal, hasn't had any joy at Atletico. You know, again, hella clubs must be interested in him or listen to offers potentially for him. But you heard Leipzig were the closest, and Nagelsmann came out and said, yo, listen, we can't afford the loan fee. So again, maybe is it a two-for-one sort of thing with Atletico? Could we flirt between the idea of bringing in a Thomas Lemar? Because on paper, could play a couple of midfield roles as well as out wide. So at least for a season, if it's on loan, that's another option for Arteta to flirt with and play with. I'm not saying that we should do that. And you, South London's finest, but he knows me way too well. And he's been watching too many DG vids because he knows this name is a name I can talk about for time. I'd love Shabazz Lai, but he seems that he's staying where he's staying. And I think Arsenal are just conceding that while he might be someone we've got a registered interest in him, we're keeping it moving. I would love him. Completely different player to Aouar, but similarities. He wants the ball. He wants to try and pass forward. He's got a lovely free kick on him, the man. You know, Shabazz Lai is a baller. I would love him, but again, I don't think it's going to happen. And for me, again, you know, even if we didn't get Partey, and I'm talking like Partey is wearing this shirt, because until he's holding up this shirt and stuff like that, I'm not getting too gassed. But you'd like to imagine there's alternative targets. If Partey didn't work, who are we getting? Aouar, which appears not to be the case, who are we getting, you know? You don't just wake up, teams don't just wake up in the summer and say, who do we want to buy? We want Aouar and Partey, you know? Obviously, the whole footballing world can see players and say, you should go in here, and business does happen late. But the bulk of a club's business, especially when we look at it, like I said, the spine is central to Arsenal, you know? The centre-half and centre-midfielders, that was a target. We must have been looking at that for months, that position for months, finding players, and then a next scout will scout the player that scouted, and then we'll rule this guy out and we'll bring this guy in, and you know, out of 20, 30 names, it will get well down to 10, and then five real feasible targets, and you can't get this guy, let's go for that. I'm on that. Listen, as an Arsenal fan, I want world-class players. I want all of that. But I'm used to players leaving. I'm used to us not getting our first choice. So if you've got alternatives, that's fine. Of course, for me, the more name brand or known the player is, you know, you got more confidence. But I don't care if the player plays in North London, like where I live, or on the edge of the earth. As long as he's competent, if he's a midfielder, if he's a defender, whatever he is, can he do his role consistently, which is another one? That's all I care about. And is he confident? Because it's not all going to go away. I think too many players at Arsenal, historically and right now, they're all great. You know, when the sun's out, when we're dominating possession, when the fans are cheering them on, they're great. But the fan, you're going to, as much as I want the fans to sing from the same hymn sheet and we all support in thick or thin, sometimes the fans are going to need inspiration. It's going to be nervy, you know. You're going to make mistakes on the football field. I need to see the confidence that, okay, you say, cool, I've done this 9 times out of 10. The one time I've done it, I've cost my team. Let me get myself back in it. I'll still try that again because mistakes happen. So all I care about is that. All I care about is alternatives. What the one thing I want to preach as well, people, in relation to Partey, he's not a messiah. He's not going to change this alone. It's the same way we looked at Mustafi to change our defensive duties. Now, Mustafi just ultimately, historically, weren't good enough at this club, but there wasn't an added emphasis on defending. In the same way, Gabriel and Saliba, more so Gabriel immediately, you can see he's a quality defender. He's still got a lot of raw elements. You know, he needs to make sure he doesn't play them under-hit passes, but he's got a lot to learn. But why is he looking good? Because he's a quality player. And because since Arteta's come in, while we might not be perfect, there's a greater emphasis on defending and our defensive outlook. And that's what you want to see from Arteta. Arteta's been showing us, you know, that he's still got a lot to learn. There still are a bit of question marks. He has done some things. I thought, wow, why has he done that? But more often than not, as all managers are a bit crazy, there's a method to Arteta's madness. There's a specific reason behind him doing anything. Without complicating it, he's shown us all something, at least initially, to get behind and to believe in until he shows us that he may or may not be the guy for the job. And again, a good tradesman, as some of you might be listening to this, never blames their tools. But at the same time, you know, you're not going to find gold using a toothpick or you're going to be doing that forever. So he's only as good as the tools he's got. So give the man half a chance. You've given him Gabriel. You know, you would have liked Saliba to be up to scratch. Clearly, Saliba might not be ready. But yeah, man, like I would have liked 4 signings in an ideal world, Saliba being used right now and or integrated more into the team and 2 central midfielders. But I'm prepared to take, you know, while it's not perfect, Gabriel, Partey, I'll take that. You know, that's 2 options that weren't there. You know, Willian, you know, at times he's going to frustrate, but he's shown he can be used. You know, I think there's a squad, there's a couple players stronger now. And I don't still think even with Partey, we might just miss out on top 4. But it is what it is in that regard. Apologies, people, because I don't want to forget what I want to talk about. I want to touch on Saliba. And I've just had a quick point on Partey, people. Apologies, got the notepad. On Partey, people. And again, I have to wonder what convinced him to stay, because on the face of it, again, I get the attraction. You know, Arsenal's a big brand. He's 27. He's 2 years older than me. So he grew up when Arsenal was actually a decent team. Arsenal's got a hella clout in Africa and especially Ghana, you know. So these are attractive reasons. Obviously, there's probably a London element to it away from football, you know, Premier League, the finances, the competitive nature of the league, London as well. Let's not be silly. We can't just focus on the club. There is that element. He is his own human being and he does have a family. You know, some teams do struggle to sign people purely because of where they are. You know, I can't debate it, but I was speaking to an agent who tried to agree a deal for a player to go to Swansea. He agreed everything and the player said, F that, I'm not on that. There's nothing to do outside of football. And he's quite a well-known footballer, people, the man in question. So that is an element. Also as well, you have to imagine, he must have had some dialogue with Arteta and Edu, but focusing on Arteta, because Edu can say what he wants until he's blue in the face. Kroenkes and the rest of it around him can say what he says. The contract is a relevant thing. And he, at 27, turning 28, Partey's contract has to be a good one or what he deems good, because your footballing career is short. But at the same time, you have to wonder what Arteta might have said to convince him, you know. Arteta, you're hearing, whether you agree with it or not, Bellerin wants to allegedly stay because of the project. You've heard Aubameyang say that as well. You've heard Willian say it as well. And while it might be, you know, expected PR sort of talk, people, on the other hand, Arteta not talking out his bum, there must be something. So what has he said to convince Partey to leave that position? Because like I said, consider the London aspect and all of those things. They're all factors, but just disregard it for a sec. Why come to Arsenal? Because, you know, many people ask the question. You're at Atletico. You're at a fantastic system. You know, you're playing for Diego Simeone. You're playing Champions League football. Why Arsenal? So I'm keen to know what would have tempted him to come to Arsenal in this delicate time that we face as a club. We finished 8th last season, you know. Forgive me if I'm wrong. It's been a mad year. So what tempted him? But either way, I'm happy with him. He makes us for me, it gives the fans something to believe in, and we ain't got too much as fans to believe in, really, you know. So I'm happy with that. Hopefully we can do a bit more moves. In terms of outgoings, you know, we've done quite poor in that aspect. If we're real, we've sold players that really that could have a future at the club, like Lucas Torreira, for a variety of reasons, you know, whether it's he never settled in this country, not playing, you know, all injuries, you know, doesn't want to stay here anymore, just never settled. There's many reasons, you know. In fact, there's also the alternative reason that I never say. Maybe Torreira was happy here and Atletico tapped him up and he said, you know, I want to go, sort of thing. And that's why he's not playing. We'll never know. But I would have liked Torreira to stay. Like I said, I think he would have been a good option in the squad. And I think, you know, in games like, I think I mentioned it ironically in a video months ago or weeks ago. That's an exaggeration. Where ironically, we're playing City after the international break. Now, I just wanted Arteta to have this sort of option in the side, in that, you know, playing against City, you need to be aggressive, you need to kind of be dominant. If we're honest with ourselves, we're not going to dominate for possession. So when you've got Partey and Torreira, two box-to-box combative figures, you can put a foot in and are a bit dynamic, that's good. Or you start one of them, you bring a next man on to kind of close out the game. I just wanted him to be able to flirt between having that option within the side. I'm keen to see who is going to be the partnership, because I do believe on one hand, We're going to see Thomas Partey and Xhaka. That's what I believe is going to be it. But then Ceballos comes into it, and I think Ceballos should start. So I'm keen to see what he wants, what he does. And it's good to see good competition for places now. And, you know, there's a lot of business still to be done. I believe someone here has said, apologies, people, wrong one. Your message is gone, but someone said, do you still want Jorginho from us? There it is. Do you still want Jorginho from us? I'm not in the know. I'm not an agent, man. I don't have a clue, my guy. But I wouldn't mind Jorginho. I'm not going to lie. He's not my first choice. I don't think he's a bad player. I don't see how he improves us. When I say that, again, he can pass the ball forward. I see how he would set up in Arteta's system and how it'd be useful. I just want midfielders who immediately, I know what piece to this jigsaw you're kind of solving. You know, Partey's coming in. Whether he's a success or another thing is another question, my dude. But immediately he comes in, we've got a box-to-box midfielder. We're more dynamic than we was. If our world or someone a bit more creative or someone that's a bit known more for creative stuff comes in, cool. I know we can pass the ball forward and things like that. With Jorginho, you know, I could see Arteta playing him and Xhaka together, which would fill me with kind of joy going forward. Defensively, there's a lot to be worked on. Or he would be competing for Xhaka's spot. And I wouldn't mind Jorginho at all. You know, there's a lot of talk of coming on loan. I don't think it's going to happen. Maybe in terms of bodies it should. But because I believe our midfield options, historically, who's calling me? That's them Buki numbers. I don't know that. Our midfield options, specific centre mids, I think they're not the strongest, you know. Partey, shout out to Partey. I've got a lot of faith in Ceballos since this resurgence. I'm a fan of Xhaka, whatever people say. The one at the Liverpool game on Monday was his first sort of bad game in how long? People forget. But I'm not going to lie, Xhaka for me is a squad player. That's it. So what we've got, Xhaka, we've got Partey, Xhaka, Partey, El Nene. Joe Willock should be used in that role, and he might just do that. You've got Ceballos. I'm not really sure over a 38-game period, 34 left in the Premier League and the Europa League and the rest to come, that's enough. Because we've got to remember, Partey, listen, I want Partey. Nobody wants Partey more than me to hit the ground running. But we do have to account for adaptation. We do have to account for potential injuries or suspensions. He's not going to, you know, that's what I mean. Not just one man can change this. You never want to rely on one player, unless they're Thierry Henry, Lionel Messi or Ronaldo. See, I slipped Henry up there with that. But I wouldn't mind Jorginho, but I don't know if it's going to happen, man. Let's just confirm the Partey thing, and then we'll see what happens past that, man. We do need reinforcements. El Nene is calm for the squad, you know. Now we've got Partey and these sort of guys, I don't think he'll play. Would I take Dominic Calvert-Lewin? You know, he's proved me wrong. I didn't think he was that good of a footballer, and he's making me look like an idiot, which I always hold my hands up. I'll take Calvert-Lewin if he continues this, you know. He scored a hat-trick. I ain't seen certain strikers at my club bag a hat-trick since they signed. Still, shout out to them strikers. I've got a lot of time for them. But, you know, I'm happy for them people. Let's talk about quick outgoings. And there's a lot of talk of Saliba leaving on loan. He's been linked with some Italian clubs, some German clubs, and Fulham. Now, for me, I wouldn't say it's concerning. 1 second, people. Thank you very much. Oh, sorry. You've sent... I don't know why it's not letting the super chat come up, but he said, bro, I digest. Jorginho is a passer that can be bullied. We need a presence that comes with Partey. My guy, I agree with that. I agree with that. That's my thought. That's why I'm not really on the Jorginho one. I'm just saying I wouldn't mind him. Like, I'm not going to be up in arms if he cries. That's what I mean by if Jacqueline and Jorginho play together, my bro, you know, going forward, it's all right. But going that way, it's the next thing. So I fully agree. I'm not disagreeing with you, but love for that, my guy. Back to outgoings. And Saliba doesn't concern me. It does to a degree because it means that he's not of the level, or he's not as ahead in his development as you would expect. And there's a lot of reasons, you know. He missed out on a bunch of football because of suspension of COVID. He had the injury. And sadly, I don't want to talk on a man's personal life, but there are rumours slash facts, which Arteta's kind of alluded to, about his personal life that will affect him. You know, people can say football is a great refuge and a great escape from problems. I can testify to that as well, my personal life. But same way, it's tough to be motivated and do things when the very few things that are more important than football are plaguing you. And setbacks are inevitable. We've got to remember he had some injuries, you know. I've watched a bit, quite a lot of Saliba at St. Etienne purely because I love you football and I like to watch our stars. I think he has the ability, same way I didn't want him to stay there on loan, I understood it. Same way I don't agree with this, but I understand it. I think he's good enough to immediately play. I think he'll learn some. I think he'll show his quality. I think he'll learn his harsh lessons. And I plead with all of you lot, if you can, if there is a way, go and watch St. Etienne versus what's the team? Mets. Habib Diallo, a man linked with Sheffield United today, yeah? Bullied Saliba. Pace, power, completely bullied. There's nothing wrong with that. You grow as a person. Same way I've seen Saliba play very well. I've seen him play people onside unnecessarily, concede a penalty, and that. These are few and beyond. But he's learning. And he's obviously had the injury. Now, this makes me believe, because if you look at Arteta's language on Saliba, it's changed slightly. It was more, yeah, you're part of the thing. Now it's to, yeah, you're part of the thing. But he's more alluding to the long term. So he's got him. So he's had him in training. Obviously, he's used him against MK Dons. He's had him. That makes me believe, you know, maybe Arteta's perception or the reports he was getting, Arteta thought is different, you know, because he thought, you know, it's good enough for you to go out alone and play football. I don't think you're ready yet. Or he might think you're a decent player, but it's worth you going out alone because of, you know, Holding's resurgence could have tipped the balance for things. Gabriel's adaptability obviously tipped it. His loyalty to David Luiz means these lot are going to play a lot of football. He probably thinks, you know what, you can, as much as I want you, you know, if anything happens to these guys and Tierney, who can be used there, you know, I've got Socrates and Mustafi who I want to move on, but they can be stayed here. Now, the difficulty is obviously some of these names I've said should be moved on. So potentially if one or two of these names move on, then Saliba stays. But I could get it if he goes to Fulham and stuff. You know, he's done very well to get to a final with St. Etienne and be part of a, you know, a mixed season for St. Etienne where they've had to, players have had to get roll their socks up. So I think Saliba thrown in at the deep end and what would be a suspected relegation race with Fulham, let's be honest, they will be in a relegation fight, would help him, you know, and he'd be under close quarters. And again, anything that he can do to make him a better footballer, I'm all on that. So I don't mind Saliba going out on loan. If I haven't mentioned it or you're just tuning in, not only is Saliba allegedly linked with a move away, Kolasinac is linked with Leverkusen, Mustafi and Socrates are linked with moves to Italian clubs. Young centre-half Daniel Ballard is joining the rest of the young players and going out on loan to Blackpool. He'll join McGuinness, he'll join John Jules, Medley and the rest of them. So that's good. Obviously, Guendouzi apparently is in talks to join her for Berlin on loan, and that'll probably be confirmed shortly, people. So, yeah, I think going back to Partey quickly, because I just see someone gone back in. I think the things that fill me with confidence in relation to can that deal be done is because, first of all, people, we don't have to do any further negotiation with Atletico because, you know, we've paid the money. We can just negotiate what we need to negotiate with Partey's team. He'll take his medical in Spain. And, you know, this doesn't just come out overnight. The club must have coordinated this for the last few periods of life now, but over the last couple, 48 hours. So there must be a delegation in Spain or there must be a Zoom call set up. Obviously, there's COVID to get this deal over the line. And I'm keen to see what happens with Partey, man, because I don't know if Ghana is playing in any international friendlies or whatnot, but it could be the perfect time because, I'm not too sure how much he would train with his teammates and train full stop because people are going abroad. But you'd imagine he's in contention. He looked fit against Villarreal. Of course, there's adaptation and whatnot, but you'd imagine, or what we're all going to talk about, if it does get confirmed, people, will he play against Man City? And I would love him to. Apologies, people. I don't want my tea to get cold. What it is as well. I didn't want to back it, people, but I'll back it with you. Yeah, man. Arteta is a. Do you know what it is? Every manager is a good talker. You've got managers will promise anything. Players will promise anything. Everybody's trying to gain what they're trying to gain, innit, my guy? But at the same time, you know, you've got to follow through. I'm pretty sure Emre sang a good song and the players bought into it. But at the same time, you know, sooner or later, you see things for what they are. And what I like about Arteta is he backs his chat. You know, Arteta's going to go through tough moments at Arsenal. If he isn't already, he's going to go through good moments. It's the times of doubt that your players have to believe in you. You know, Pep Guardiola's got his own question marks at Man City now. But I can't remember which specific Pep Guardiola book. But when he started off at Barcelona, there was a segment in the book where he, you know, they lost their game. There was all these question marks and he was in the room stressing. And Iniesta, who he said is well known as to be one of the most quietest players, came in and said your tactics were effing amazing, we'll get it right, and look where it went on. So that's what I'm saying. If they didn't believe, they believed in him at the worst of times, and look how it ended for Pep. So that's what I'm not saying Arteta's going to go off and listen, people, I'd love to say that I want to win Champions League, but I'm just saying you've got to believe in something. And again, I still think there's more to be done. I do think Arsenal, you know, we was playing the waiting game, we played a poker game, but it would have been lovely if we reached this conclusion earlier, got Partey in earlier, integrated him earlier, maybe put more, pardon me if it makes sense, more focus on maybe resurrecting the Aura deal or pursuing Plan B targets. Because listen, the euphoria of Partey, you know, Arsenal fans, we weren't positive, too tough bringing in Partey or anyone as time went on. But you know, if we can bring in a creative man, we've got more options. And I think that's all Arsenal fans want. We just want to genuinely believe. Like, I think even with Partey, it's still a tough choice, people, but it's still a tough target, but at the same time, it's just giving us something to believe in. Trust me, man. Let's hope for the best, man. Make sure you're all smashing the like button, people. I'm seeing over 1,000 people in here. You know, there should be like at least 900 likes. I know you lot are doing me dirty. Moderators, get onto that, man. Come on, people. I don't ask you lot for much, but get them likes in. So yeah, man, I'm happy to see Partey. I don't want to count my chickens way too early, people, because like I said, he's not signed for the club right now. I can't see him signed for the club right now holding our shirt, but it's as good as done, allegedly, people. So let's see what happens, man. Let's see what happens. I hope Aura comes as well, my guy. I really hope he comes to the club. It's just outgoings now. Can we get some outgoings now? Can we raise some figures? Because you'd imagine any target that we can't get now, they've got to be delayed for 6 months, you know. Can we go and get it done in January? The only thing I will say is the future of young Balogun now. Now, he's been linked with a lot of clubs over the summer. He was linked with, what, 5 million move to Brentford last January. We rejected it. If he doesn't move today, you know, or he's allowed to talk from January to teams abroad for free. He's been linked with German clubs. So we run the risk of losing him. So for me, even we'll be entitled to a compensation fee because he's offered him deals and he's under the age of 24. But it would be pennies. You know, even if we've got to take 2 million today and a sell-on clause, just because, you know, you've got some figure for the guy. And at the end of the day, you know, you are going to see players leave. It costs our academy around 2 million to run. So, you know, Balogun selling for 2 million because of his potential, you know, and I know it's a Zhang. But technically, the academy's paid for itself for a player that for that year and kept the lights on for a year, for a player that ain't nowhere near the first team or made an appearance for the first team based on what we're led to believe. So we'll have to see, man. Come on, man. Let's get it to 300. Let's get it further than that. There's 1,000 of you, man. What are you lot doing? What are you lot doing? Love for everybody who's like, just love for everybody who's tuned in right now as well, man. Listen, he probably is. And to be fair, it's in the best interest for Aura to do that, really. You know, I would have loved him to come to the club. You know, Lyon's season has started a bit shaky from this. I think they got, what, 7 points or so from 6 games? I could be wrong, but it's something calam like that. But it suits Aura, you know. All he needs to do right now is get his head down, play again, and everything will take care of itself, really. The move will come. And, you know, the COVID market, in an ideal world, teams will have more finances because fans will get it back in the stadium and things next year. If he takes care of himself and he keeps getting into the French side of stuff, these moves will happen. These Juventuses and Real Madrids and Barces, who he was apparently holding out for, they will come. So which is quite sad for us, obviously, because we had a free, in the same way it looked like no one was really going for Partey. We missed out on Aura. I just really want that creative man. Like, Aura is an Arsenal player. He's everything Arsenal's DNA. He's everything Wenger installed in Arsenal, really and truly. And I know many of you will get annoyed. It's sad to see Gunnosaurus leave, my guy, man. It's sad to see anybody lose their job. Someone that's been here for more years than I've been alive, potentially, or something mad like that. It's sad that people are losing their jobs. They've done him dirty, but it is what it is, man. it is what it is. We've got another super chat. Apologies, it's not coming up on the screen. But it said, if Arsenal get Partey and Aouar, then they'll be considered as serious contenders for top three slots. These two players complement the team and each other. And I agree, they do complement the team and each other very well. It would give me more confidence to have a positive season. But I'm not convinced, my guy. They're two players as part of 11. There's still question marks over not only the rest of the team, the other nine players that would be part of this 11 if them two signed. But also the depth purposes and also our tactics, you know. In an ideal world, we don't want to be playing three at the back. Or if we're going to be playing three at the back, can we play with a more attacking intent? You know, in isolation, these 19 pass moves are fantastic from Arteta. They're the result of working on the training ground. They're everything I wanted to see under Emery playing out from the back. But if we're honest, they're too far and beyond. We had two shots in the second half against Sheffield United, match of the day said allegedly. We took 28 minutes or so to have a shot against Sheffield United in the first half. Is this a way a team that wants to get top four should be starting against a team that prior to playing us hadn't scored and in fact have no points on the board? You know, six straight defeats prior to playing us. We made it seven. Is that the way we should play? You know, bar the Fulham game, my guy, you know, have we looked perfect across all incidences? No, we haven't. You know, we got away with it even against Leicester in the Carling Cup. You know, I think we were toothless to a degree and we shot ourselves in the foot on Monday and we done well on Thursday. You know, against West Ham, we got away with it. Sheffield, you know, there were moments we made it hard for ourselves and we made it a bit nervy in terms of game management, conceding cheap goals. So there's still a long way to go. It's what we do need is the personnel. Then we need to work with it, mold it, become consistent. Because for all Arteta speaks about, the one thing he bangs on about and the one thing that gravitates me, he talks about consistency. This team or this fan base or this club, we're going to live or die by consistency. Consistency is what's going to see us get top four and improve on last season. You know, it's no good being good in patches. It's no good putting three wins out of four this first little bit of the Premier League off before the international break. And then you go into the toughest period where, again, it's tough to get points, but in no order, what you've got, what's it? You've got Leicester, you've got City off the top of my head. I'm sure you've got United. You're pretty sure we got Southampton and Spurs. A good round, a tough gamut of fixtures that anyone else fighting for top four around us is kind of licking their lips at Arsenal going to that. You need to come out of that with some respectable points. Like I said, we need to be getting out of December looking in January still mathematically in for a choice. I don't think it's a divine right to get top four. I still think it'll be a failure if we get top four, but I just want to see improvements towards that. I want to see light at the end of the tunnel. I want to see us closer than we was last year. You know, the amount of draws, the amount of points dropped from winning positions, you know, the way we played against some top six rivals prior to Arteta and historically just haven't been good enough of a team that wants to get back to where they previously was. So, yeah, man, keep hitting the like button, people. 500 likes is the minimum. Come on, man, can we get to that? I'll back a shot of Ray Neff if we ever got to that, because I don't think it's going to happen, man. You know what, Atletico fans, it is what it is. They must be feeling how I feel, because I'm happy with Partey if suspected it does happen, but I'm bittersweet that Torreira is leaving. It was writing on the wall, and they might be feeling the same. It is what it is. They kind of known that he apparently would be leaving for a while. Like you said, Partey is what we need, my guy. If we don't get parted, then it's an L, you know. But I'd imagine that medicals and all these things are a bunch of formalities, because we must have got these things confirmed and whatnot, man. Come on, man. Smash the like button. Love my guy, Jeffrey or Mr. Hines. Come on, Colin. Yeah, man. It's bittersweet. I feel the only thing I can criticize is if Partey comes in is that there's no creative player that's come to accompany that. And also the sense of outgoings. There's still too much mix and match got players. There's players you could say could have a role, could force their way into Arteta's plans, but there's also players we know we need to move on from, especially at centre half. There's still too much. You know, when you go cash converters or CEX back in the days to buy a pre-owned game and there's them games in a box for like 99p, that's what it reminds me of, a couple of centre half players at Arsenal. We need to move them on. I don't mind signing a creative player from the English Premier League, but it'd probably have to be in the Championship or something, purely because there's some good players. I would like Grealish. You all saw him bad up Liverpool, but that's costing 70, 100 million, whether he's worth that or not. So we're going to get zanged. You need to go for these players before they kind of advance. Love for that, man. Love for that, Anfield, man, and especially because you're not an Arsenal fan. You've got nothing to do with us. So it means a lot that you've tuned into my team. Means a hell of a lot, my guy, man. And it means a lot that you've all tuned in, whoever you are, wherever you are. I'm seeing people in Australia saying it's 1 a.m. and that's crazy, people, that you lot are tuning in. You lot get some sleep, though, man. My videos will be here. I don't know, Chris. You tell me. Who said that? I hope it's getting closer, my guy. I hope it's getting closer. And I'm really hoping, man. Man said we're in talks with Harry Maguire. Lie that, man. We're going to go on timeout for promoting stupidness. Samora, I wouldn't mind it. I wouldn't mind it. Samora can pass the ball going forward. I wouldn't mind it. But it's not exactly the creative player I want. But it upgrades our midfield still. It's more dynamic. You know, it's IC3. It's technical quality and pace and power. So I'd be all up for that, my guy. I'd be all up for that. 10:30 in Malaysia. Big up yourselves, man. This is what I'm saying. This is football. Football amazes me, but it amazes me more when I'm seeing, look, Kuwait, Jamaica. Somebody said New Zealand. Where's your comment? It's Ethiopia. It's crazy, man. Come on, people, get the likes up. It's you lot are tuning in from some crazy places, and it just sums up how great football is, people, that we can all be connected, obviously courtesy of the internet, but our love for football in many cases. I'm watching from my school in Texas. Hey, man, make sure you get them grades, man. I don't want you to be the reason you don't get your grades and have the career you want to have, man. I'll be here after, man. You can tune in again. But hey, I'm not going to lie to you, man. I love the support, man. It gasses me that you lot will find a way to include me in your life. Serbia, you see what I'm saying? Mad places. Texas again. America, 8 a.m. So I don't even know. I don't even know for your, you know, the state you're in and all of those things. I don't think we're overestimating Auro. I do understand what you mean. I do think fans are sensationalizing. He can be hot and cold. There is still a lot of development he needs to do, especially if he wants to go to them clubs. But I think it's undoubtedly a boost to us, our hopes of getting top four. I do think he has a lot of quality. I do think he has scope to get better. And there's very few players we're going to sign that are in their prime. You know, I do think the days of grabbing an Ozil for 32 million or however much it was, or Alexis Sanchez, you know, which was how much would that be in this today's day and age? These times, there's still deals to be had. Parties, I'm saying this part is 45 million release clause. But, you know, I think them days are gone. So we actually probably have to try go for these players that have the potential. Or it just, you know, when you see Auro, like, he's good. He's probably a bit inconsistent in playing to higher levels. But if we can get him before them big boys, then we can either make a change. It's a bit like Mane, you know. Liverpool had a good little tactic. No one was rating Salah's team. They bought Salah after he rebuilt himself at Roma. Nobody was rating Mane at Southampton. People were taking him in, but there was bare Ooman and Aaron. Like, should we not? They bought him. He's got better, you know. Is what it is. So we need to, like Raul Wasanye once said, we need to outsmart the market, man. We need to. Out of our current centre-backs, who's the best centre-back to pair Gabriel with if we played 4-4-2 or 4-2-3, 4-3-3? I don't know where I was getting that formation from. But at present, I would say David Luiz. You know, they've both got the Portuguese understanding. They're both countrymen. You know, you've got the experienced lad to the naive lad. Long term, I want it to be Saliba without a doubt. But I think the best partners right now for Gabriel are the ones he's played the most with. He's played a lot with David Luiz. He's played a lot with Gabriel. You know, I guess him and Tini would be awkward, two left footers. Not that you can't have two right footers, but I'd say out of Manda, actually centre halves, David Luiz and then Rob Holding. You know, they've played the most with him. Time to get back Ramsey. Fat chance, my guy. It seems like Perlo's messing with him. See, three a.m. in New Zealand. This is a mazza. What time is it over here in England? It's 3:30. I tried to get Turkish on the stream with me, my guys, man. I think he's busy or something. I don't know. Yeah, he's not about still. He ain't. It's quite disappointing, man. I wanted my guy Turkish, but big up Turkish. He must be busy, man. Jamaica, you know I got a lot of time, man. Back a cheesy beef patty for me, gentlemen. Need that. And this is it, my guy. This is what people don't understand. It's a squad game. There's lots of fixtures, you know. You got to account for loss of form, etc. You know, loss of form, injuries, fixture pile up. You know, some games, you know, that's why I wanted Torreira, because it don't make sense, people. But for this example, there might be some games that suit a Torreira, some games that suit a Partey, sometimes that suits a both of them. And just forget Partey, just focused on both of the players, people. We need different options. Every midfielder should be able to be, you know, it should be a different sort of meal, you know. Can we, you know, if we want an expansive partnership, you bring in a Ceballos and someone or whatever. Somebody said, hey, wait, quickly, people, where's the drink? I'm a man of my word. We're not doing a mazza because I didn't even prepare for that, but you saw it going. Oh, the honey kind of helped. But there's the shot, man. I've done it for you. I'm a man of my word. I don't cap. But we've got another thingy. I would welcome more Kalajdzic, Xhaka, Sokratis, all them leaving than Partey and Arrow coming. With all due respect, my guy, I think you're capping a bit. You know, that's cap, man. You know, there's nothing like bringing in a player that's a good player and whatnot. I think that's cap. I do see your angle in that you want to move players on and that, but it is what it is, man. You're capping, man. I wouldn't mind Benrahma, but it seems that that one isn't for us. That one there is gone. That one there is gone. Hey, send me some flavors, man. You don't know, but it just seems that them one there is, like, the Benrahma one's gone, my guy. Love, my guy. We got Ricardo tuning in from Kingston. It's amazing. Man said Turkish having a bath in the jacuzzi. 600 likes. Can we get to that, people? Over 1,000 people tuned in. I think this is my most successful stream ever. So big up everyone involved in this thing. It means a lot. Are we signing Partey? Hell yeah, we're signing Partey, man. Hopefully it happens. Bro, listen, without being too critical, you know, without being too critical of Rob Holding, you know, it's not fair to say that. And at the same time, you know, hopefully, I don't like to be them guys who say hopefully the professionalism thing can pass off on Partey, but it can. And I think one point that's gone over my head is Partey's got a lot of quality going forward. But when you consider, you know, the intelligence you have to show to play in a Simeone team, have a specific role and implement it, you know, when you're talking about three at the back, five in midfield, technically, he can be great in that. It's the same way Awa can play on the left-hand side of a pivot very well. It's what needed. And we've got a lot of games, man, so we need a lot of options on a general basis in three games a week. So let's not get onto anyone in the squad. Like, even Elneny, you know, Elneny's done well in the chances he's had. Of course, tip 9 times out of 10, I don't want Elneny to play. But we're going to need everyone to stand up to be counted. And that's what every player in the Arsenal team should feel like. From Reece Nelson to, if you do stay, I know he's got a hamstring injury, and we will talk about Nelson. But everyone's got to believe their chance is coming. Everyone's time is coming. It's a bit like Martinez, you know. Probably didn't think he was going to get the amount of game time, but you've got to train like your chance is coming. And when it comes, take it, you know. It's like Callum Hudson-Odoi. He's kind of seized his opportunity at Chelsea. He ain't been perfect, but he seized it in the last couple of games. You know, we talk about young players all the time. But we need to get, yeah, another shot at 700 likes. But you know, I'm going to get to 700 likes. I don't believe Aubameyang was lied to. Still, he might. I would have said he was lied to if I didn't hear this Partey thing was coming in. And to a degree, there might be some false promises there. But, you know, I don't think he was lied to. I think he was at least told something of conviction by Arteta. Can we get that, people? Come on, if you lot can get that, then we'll do our thing. Love, my guy, for adding your like, man. Another guy that understands it only takes 2 seconds. Already on 650. Jesus, you lot are doing a mazza. I don't think anybody's ready per se to make immediate impact, but there are some players I think are calling, man. You know, you've got some good players in the 23s and 18s. Check out the rest of the vids. I don't need to go in depth, but you've seen them. They're calling, man. Our under 23s have had a poor start to the season, though. I can't even cap. Would I try and get Zanoli? Well, he's just had a massive injury, right? So it seems that at least even if I do want him, you know, we're going to have to base off from that. Yes, I do. I think he's earned enough experience and to do this thing. But as to whether we're going to go for him, it doesn't appear such, my guys. Is someone bringing the latest rumours that are happening? Because obviously I ain't checked my phone. Is there anything else circulating with Arsenal? Is it just the Guendouzis, the Jorginhos, the Parteys, you know, the Awa talk or Hope of Awa? You know, the typical players at Arsenal that are linked with moves away. Is there anything new circulating? Or is there any, what's circulating at other clubs? You know, the most exciting thing I saw was Callum Hudson-Odoi going to Bayern Munich, and that one there seems to be dead in the water. So is there anything of relevance? I see Ben Godfrey go to Everton. Big signing. Apparently 20 million right now, and it can rise. 5 million deal. I think he's going to get England call up. I think he's going to be a fantastic signing. That's someone I wanted at Arsenal. Please don't make me look like an idiot for saying that, but I think he's a certified player, man. Probably, my guy. That's what I'm inclined to believe, Shaquille, initially, man. And you're right. Where is it? Somebody said back your team, and you're right. That's what you have to do. You have to back your team. I don't know, man. I still think we'll fall short of the top four, but I've got faith in Arteta, man, especially if he does get some reinforcements. It closes at 11, my dude. It is 3:33 right now, English time. I'm poor at maths, but I know you're better, so pattern that up, man. Love all my Ghanaians for tuning in, man. You know, hey, someone make me some jollof rice for when Partey comes, man. I'm there, my guys. Partey's needed if this thing happens. What else? You agree that we really blown it with Awa? Well, apparently, latest reports I'm seeing online and people what's the word, you know, sensationalize things and overdo it a bit, people. Apparently we had a fee agreed and Ula said, no, we want more. So there's not much we can do past that. I do think there must have been a real hope for Arawa, but that one there is probably gone, people. He ain't been sold. He's gone out on loan. And I do think he'll go off to be a better player and whatnot. And if he was to look at it like that, you could say, yeah, why wouldn't Arsenal keep him if he developed? But he burnt his bridges. And I think Arteta's got to stamp his authority. You know, Arteta's had enough. So, you know, it is what it is. You know, he's, as much as I like Guendouzi, and he's clearly got quality because he's played numerous times. And even Arteta started him a big game against City. No one's bigger than the club. If the manager's trying to implement something and you're not with it, then he's got to make an example of you. You know, there's better players in the squad, more accomplished members in the squad that gave Arteta his full, their full eyes and ears. So who are you? I'm not saying Guendouzi said that. I'm just going off what reports say. So that's it, man. I'd entertain it. I'm not going to lie to you. If we're not going to bring someone else in, I'd entertain it, man. Love my guy, man. Hopefully, if they go back, if they leave, they still need 30 million. Well, let's be the ones to get in that 30 million then. What this? Go and get in the peas, man. Someone sent a super chat and it's gone. I love that you lot are sending so much messages. But hey, moderators, help me, man. Make sure these things don't get lost. You know, Grealish, I like Grealish, man. But yeah, like you said, we can't do that. The bands aren't there unless they're going to help us out, which they wouldn't. You know, why would Villa want to lose their key player? Hey, listen, Nigerians, Ghanaians, all sorts of people who make jollof rice, I'm not involved. I enjoy all nations jollof. You know, I like jollof. You lot fight it out as to who's got the best. I leave the Caribbean folk, not Jamaicans, because we can't talk about who's better. Roti is better. Stay out of that. I'm just going to enjoy the food. I'll be the judge. You lot cook up the thing, bring it to man. You lot fight it out. Big up you, man. That makes me laugh. No, man. So much Australians here, man. I go to bed. It's 1 a.m. You lot are mad, man. 30, man. I big up you lot. Yeah, man. I'm one of the few that are hoping that Guendouzi and Arteta, you know, this year away from each other, they can pattern up, become a bit more mature. And then what's the word that they see you be using on Twitter? Is it rotunda? A rotunda from Guendouzi would be needed. SB's art, thank you for your super chat. That five was probably gonna buy me some MacD's. Lovely. You said, would you take, let me not eat MacD, let me get something healthy. Would you take Dele Alli from Tottenham Hotspur? I love Dele Alli as a footballer, but it's not going to happen, is it? And to be fair with you, he is a creative player, but he's not been playing to any high standard that I think he'd fix any problem. So, no. But I hope he gets... Listen, I know he plays for Spurs, but let's hope he gets back on track. I think Mikel likes Emil Smith-Rowe as well, but he's got to show he's ready. You know, clearly he weren't ready last year. Hopefully with that, you know, Huddersfield thing under his belt, he shows he's ready to go again. He's ready to fight. He's got more desire and shows more consistency. I think he likes him and I think he's a player of the future and I would use him. But equally, we need man that are kind of here for now, or like I was one for the future, but he's kind of more ready now, if you get what I'm saying. So, you know, it's up to Emil. Initially, you'd imagine if he is going to get chances, it's in the latter stage. Well, it's against City, if anything, in the Carling Cup. And it's also in the Europa League, but it's down to him, you know. For me, Emil's best as a 10 or creative hub of the team. But, you know, he probably, just in terms of depth, will probably put pressure on wide options as well. And it's just down to him, you know. For Eddie, for Joe Willock, for all of these players, it's down to them now. You know, Callum Hudson-Odoi, even same example at Chelsea. They need opportunities. They need a constant run in the team, you know. They are young. But at the same time, I agree with all of that. I cut them all some slack. It's sink or swim. Saka's grabbed his chance. Not everyone's going to be like Saka. Not even just ability. I'm talking about grabbing chances. Saka is going to go through hard moments and tough moments and times where he's struggling, you know. It's a career, you know. Everything. I'm not going to say everything's gone right for Saka. I don't know his life and he probably has gone through adversity. But in terms of first team, it's all gone right. He can do no wrong. There's going to be a moment where him and Martinelli, it's like that, you know. Same way Nelson and them man there. Nelson, when he was in academy, you know, best thing since sliced bread. He's been hitting first team and it's been difficult for him. You know, not everyone's going to hit it right. You can't just, even me, it's tough to break it down to people when they say to me, even my man them say, oh, Saka's done it. Why can't he do it? And I get that. Like, so my guy, I got a friend here. He's an Arsenal fan, but he's not with this youngster thing. He believes in youngsters. He wants young players to get opportunities. But if you're not with it straight away, he's not on it. That's why he says the only young players he really rates right about now is Phil Foden, Greenwood, and Saka, because they grab their chances. Everybody else is on the play plating, you know. And as much as I want the young players of the future, and I love the Haaland, I love the Joes, I love the Eddies and all of it, they've got to be ready now. And listen, Eddie, you can't really get onto Eddie. He didn't have the best of games against Sheffield, but out of all the young players, excluding Martinelli and Saka, he's growed in stature in terms of a squad base the most. He's keeping out Lacazette. I don't see Joe Willock keeping out Xhaka or anyone in the midfield. I don't. Joe might get starts, but I don't see him genuinely keeping any of them out. And that's not a criticism. That's a fact. Eddie went from going out alone, being a squad player, to now he's elevated slightly to a rotation option. For whatever reason, Lacazette didn't play. And even last season, he kept him out, you know? So I'm inclined to believe Eddie's going to get significant football when he earns it this season, you know? Same way Saka's been earning it, you know? You've got to earn it. But at the same time, Nelson and that, they've got to be selfish. You've got to do what you can do for a year from now. Are you dramatically better? Is Arsenal the best place for your development, Nelson? On many ways, I believe it is. But on the same token, I believe, can you go somewhere you can play 20, 30 games? Same goes for Emil. And the same definitely goes for Joe. Because Joe, out of all the youngsters, I won't say he's struggling the most, because he's about, and there's been different managers and they've used him. But I don't really see what Joe is. I see a bit of box to box. I see why he plays in the 10, even though I don't think that's him. I don't see enough. I don't think his footballing IQ is improved enough. I don't think his decision making is improved enough. I don't think the positions he takes up on the field have improved enough. I just don't think it's there enough. There's a legit case for him to go out on loan. Now, we probably need him for the squad. Then in the position he finds himself in at Arsenal, he's not going to be in any rush to depart. But they've got to be selfish. Selfish in a way that you need to do what you can do to be a dramatically better player a year from now. You could, before you know it, you'll hit a bump where Arsenal say, ah, you know what, there's other young players getting up. We'll develop and do elsewhere. You see, use green screen. You see the problem with using the green screen? I'm going to do it soon, but on StreamYard, for some reason, it makes it mad pixelated. Like, my head is all squashed in. So I just think, rather than mash up you lot's eyes, I'll just leave it like this. Both, man. Both. I'm sorry, my guy. I got you. Because I'm biased to Saka, but Greenwood, I've watched him at United from the youth times. He's a baller. I've got to say both. They've both got their different qualities. For Saka, I know he's adaptable and he can do everything. For Greenwood, I know he's a killer in front of goal. So it's a difficult one. I don't think Partey in isolation is enough, but it's enough to move in the right direction. I am seeing people big up from Sweden, man. Love, my guy. I personally think Joe Willock's best role is the box-to-box thing. I don't think he's got the intelligence to be playing in the 10 role. I'm prepared to be wrong. I think box-to-box is him. He's good with driving the ball and whatnot. I like his hunger, people. I think yesterday showed Eddie's got to mix it up a bit. He's got to offer a bit more, not in terms of hold-up players, but he can improve in that. Link-up play. He don't really look polished. You know, Lacazette, for all he's got the little things to do what he needs to do. Big up Zorro, where you told Omar we're getting him. Jeez. I didn't need, boy, keep me up to date. Keep me up to date. Another shot. Look. And my mum watches these people. So if I get in trouble, if she calls me from her yard and says there's an issue, you know who I'm coming to, people. I'm only putting in here because there's honey. I can't lie to you. Oof. Yeah, that was tough. He can improve in everything. Maybe make himself a bit more unpredictable. But I like Saka. He's got good balance. I think, you know, if I was a defender, I don't know what way he's going to turn. You know, I think he's doing his thing. Killy. Them Kilburn G's. Big up all myself and North Killy and all them places there. Kilburn and all that, man. North and Northwest are two different places, but it means a lot. We've got some Kosovo folk in here. Big up, man. It means a lot. Somebody asked me about Inas Hagi's son at Rangers. I can't see the message anymore, and I hope I pronounced his name right. I'm not really a fan, you know. I think he's a baller. He's got technical ability, but I'm not really a fan. I think there's a lot more development before I talk about going elsewhere. Hate to talk about this, but what is your stance on Ozil? Now, Ozil, we got to keep it moving. We've got to move him on. But for me personally, I'm not saying he should be in the first team. But if he's going to be here at least for a year and he's not a disruptive figure, I don't see why he can't use him in the Europa League. I don't see why he can't be on the bench and things like that. That one there is clearly above Arteta, in my opinion, but let's not focus on him. People, should we quickly look at some rather trying to take him back on loan? It makes sense. It makes full sense. I said that. You might as well let him go back on loan to St. Etienne. You know, they've lost Fufana. He's gone to Leicester. He's going to be a good signing. You know, why not let him go back to where he feels the most important and they kind of know him and all of that. And you know, there's not really having to adapt to tactics and all of that per se. Why not let him go back to St. Etienne? It would make sense. Who will have the better season? Well, for me, I hope to say Pepe. 70 million. We're expecting more immediate impact. Saka's just a breath of fresh air, because you're just surprised he's 19. So in the hope that Pepe has the season we all need him to shut our fans up, I'm going to say Pepe, my dude. Excuse me for a sec, people. I'm still here, obviously. Well, I'm still going to stay right in front of you. I just want to see if there's any, what else is happening in the market. I'm going on The Athletic right now. Deadline day latest. Their deadline day is kind of dead still. Like, that's a dead sort of thing. So let's see, man. We've got Sky Sports. Deadline day latest. Right, you got Cavani and Telles undergoing medicals. Mad. Undergoing medicals at United. Theo Walker is set to have a medical for a loan move from Everton to Southampton. You know, he left as a boy, he returns as a man. Crazy. Daniel Ballard already, a 21-year-old, has joined Blackpool on loan for the rest of the season. Raw. QPR are closing in on a deal to sign Benfica forward Chris Woolock. Crazy for 750 million. Crazy how much Arsenal thingies. Adama Traore is linked with signing a new deal. Don't know why they found the need to put that one into thingy. Chupa Moting, the 31-year-old, signed a 2-year deal with Bayern Munich, people. His agent is a madness. And they've also signed Douglas Costa on a season-long loan from Juventus. Juventus apparently are about to sign Chiesa. Telles will be a good signing for United. Apparently, Chris Smalling's potential move to Roma on deadline day is proving difficult, people. We'll have to see. Cavani at 33 years of age. I don't mind that. I think he gives United a different sort of edge, a different sort of game plan and whatnot. So we'll have to see how that one there develops, people. But, you know, they've got him. They've got Ighalo on loan. You know, that's probably with Ighalo busting out in mind. So we'll have to see. So it's a difficult one. So, yeah, man. Let's see what else is there. I might do another show, another live show with my United guy, people. In relation to Manchester United. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what I meant. I swear I said 750K, man. Come on, man. Hey, hey. 750 million. I weren't paying attention, my guys, like that, man. You lot know what I meant. 800 likes. That's another shot. Every time it goes up by 100, it's going up, people. And it's a good thing I'm immune to this RNF thing now. I assume so. Baller, would like to see if he can replicate it. A man said, maybe my dude. Then you day. I wouldn't mind Brendia, my dude, but it all depends. It all depends what they offer, my guy, man. Like, what do they want? Like, I know for the English lads, they said the bidding starts at 20-30 million euros. So what do they want for my man? It all depends, man. I'm on that, though. He's a good player, man. Hey, Ethan Jones, my tug. What are you telling me, my guy? 1,000 likes. You really think we can get 1,000 likes? I don't think so, my guy. But you lot are the best at proving me wrong, as you lot have shown with all the support you've given me financially and just motivation. You lot are crazy people. It means a lot. It means a lot. Thomas Partey posted a pic. Let me see. Don't be gassing me, people. Don't be gassing me. There's not really much exciting news. Like, the Callum Hudson-Odoi is there. You know, a man, Merson almost said he fell off his chair when he's heard Arsenal are bidding for my man. Apparently, Man United are in talks to sign Alma Traore, the young 18-year-old. He's a baller. That'll be a good signing. He might not impact them immediately, but he's someone that will prove his worth. Apparently, De La Feo is going to Udinese on loan. You know, he'll probably return to Watford if they got promoted. Quickly over the Partey thing again, people. I've been speaking about it, but Darmish Chef on Sky Sports has said, throughout the whole of this transfer window, we know Arsenal have been after a midfielder and three names have been coming up. Chelsea's Jorginho. Not sure if that one is going to happen, but Arsenal have retained an interest. Hossam Aouar from Lyon was the big one, but Lyon have said all along that Arsenal's offer was timid, and then the player came out and said he was staying. The one that was never battered was Atletico Madrid's Thomas Partey. We know Arsenal have had an interest in him for the entire window. The one issue was whether they could match the release clause, because Athletic will not negotiate with any club, let alone Arsenal, on the release clause, which is 45 million. It is our understanding that Arsenal are now pushing again for Partey, and there is an expectation, although it's not 100%, that they will meet that 45 release clause. All of the talk during the window was how Arsenal were going to generate that money. Today, they are looking at releasing some of those players to fund that move. So again, I think the quicker we see some movement in relation to other players, the quicker we'll confirm our deal. In relation to City, it looks like Eric Garcia is trying to go back to Barcelona. He wants to go back. Apparently, Tolson, the other centre-half, wants to keep it moving. Apparently, Patrick Roberts is expected to leave Man City and go back to Middlesbrough. So it's been an interesting day, and there's a lot of moves to happen if you want to be playing consistent football. Spare a thought for players like Declan Rice, who doesn't appear to be having his moves sorted. Or not that Zaha has been pushing for a move in particular this window, but him as well. You know, there's a lot of players that are going to have to sit on their hands a bit, at least until January, or just have to get on with it until the end of the season. Spurs have done good business, in my opinion, in relation to their signings. They've signed 6 players, and, you know, and if they could get a centre-half, that would cap off a wavy summer for them personally. But it is what it is in that regards, man. What else is there? There isn't much. Should we move to Sky Sports? Yeah, all right, moderators, get rid of them spammers. We ain't got time for no scammer boy, mad boy. Oh, good question here. Kyle, what do I think about Adeloma Lookman's development? I don't know, my guy. I've seen him play for Fulham. He don't look really confident, you know. I can't put my hand on it, man. I don't know, my guy. I don't know why it's been so hard for him, you know, because in hindsight, I didn't think he was getting enough football at Everton. But there's got to be a reason he weren't getting at Everton. He went to Leipzig second time round and it didn't happen. And he's now got to do his thing at Fulham. I don't know, but it's disappointing, man. I like Lookman a lot, man. I really like Lookman. I'm not from South, but he's from Enns. He's a nice guy. He does a lot for charity. He's a good player. He appears to be a confidence lad. But yeah, man, is what it is. He sacked a man in a costume. Come on, man, chill off. You don't want to get put in timeout. Calm down, man. He's 18, 19. Relax. I want him to stay, but we need to... It's not the BO and then do, because if he got thrown in and he's not ready, man are going to say he needs to go out on loan and this like that. Forget the price tag and focus on the man's age. I don't mind Lamar on loan. I think I spoke about this earlier and in another video. I don't mind the Lamar on loan, you know. If we have to be a bit crafty and a bit cheeky with finding some creative players, I don't mind that. Lamar can play in a couple of roles, which obviously Arteta can flirt between for himself, sort of thing. Somebody sent another. Big up FM Sheik. He said, if we pay Partey's clause, then we surely could get our theory is Partey is going to happen. Leon seemed open to negotiations to fit our budget. You know, I think it's come down to this ain't happening unless you give Leon what they want, because the players come out and said he's staying. So unless you can revisit that in January, unless you give them what the hell they want, it's a myth. Big up Abdullah, man. Hey, moderators, ban the scammers. The man said scammers, the spammers. What other positions do we need to improve on other than bringing in a creative centre mid? If it was up to me, I do believe we need a creative centre mid. I do think left back is an area of Kolasinac leaves. You know, ideally you want Saka and Maitland-Niles playing in other natural roles, you know, for Maitland on the right-hand side at right back, for Maitland, for Saka in midfield. I'd say that. I think we've got to look at maybe a striker, because I think most teams, you know, with Cavani going to United, with, you know, Tammy and Werner and Giroud at Chelsea, with Spurs bringing in a plan B striker to go with Bell and Kane, you know, there is a lot, and us having Lacazette for all his criticisms, there is a luxury in having plan B strikers, a good striker on the bench, in the same way that a very good backup number 2 seems to be too far and beyond in football. I believe the same goes for a striker. So that would be an area. Unpopular opinion, and it's just unpopular because it's mine. If the chance of a winger that is substantially better than what we have, I'm sorry, I know there's a lot of depth, but I'm all up for it. I cannot lie. If it's one of them players that can play in a couple of roles, I'm all up for it. I cannot lie to you. I really can't lie. I hope it is. He might be, but they called Mane washed. They're called Salah washed. And at the end of the day, a loan fee, you know, a loan fee isn't the best. A loan spell wouldn't be the worst. I don't mind bringing him into the club, man. Yeah. Please just go and look outside and read some reports, my guy, man. I mean, I won't be one of them waiting outside there. I think Bellerin would improve if he was given some constant competition. But to be fair, in the second half, he played quite well. I think, listen, I said it earlier. If Reece Nelson could go out on loan and play some consistent football or go somewhere, he can get 20 games. It's something to think about for him, man. Pogba would slot in, but, you know, that's a dream. I mean, it does look up for grabs, but Arsenal need to focus on getting top four first. You know, I'd love to do the Leicester Tig winning the league, but let's just focus on getting back in the top four. No, I'm from North London still. Hope so, man. I want people to get off Bellerin's back still. Really do. Hey. That's what I want to see, man. I think Pepe needs a run of games. I want to see Aubameyang through the middle personally, but we'll have to see what happens, man. Nah, man, he should stick to YouTube vids, my guy. That guy should stick to YouTube vids. Now, Bergwijn's calm. He seems to have fallen off a bit. Yeah, I've heard we're signing a young striker from Malmo. He looks about 6 foot odd. I don't know nothing about him, my guy, so I'm not going to cap. You know, I haven't even had time to do no research, but, you know, it gives us depth for the under-18s. If he develops, maybe the 23s. Who knows, man? I rate him, my guy, man. I think a cam should be our priority because I say priority, but I'm reading out yours. I think a cam is equally as important. I rate Partey. I think fans are sensationalizing players as we do. You know, they were sensationalizing Aura and putting him on a level he's not, even though he's a good player. But yeah, man, I think he's a good player still. I think he's a good player. I rate Partey. I'm not just saying that because he's getting us, coming to us. I'd like Grealish, but we ain't got 70 million. And I think it hit a certain like, so a finger's a fish. Got to keep it real, people. A like is a like. Eat that. Ooh. Jeez. Come on, man. Let's get the likes up. It's almost 4 o'clock. I should be doing the next live with my guy, really. So, yeah. Let me tell him. Just wrapping up. People, come, man. Let's get the likes up. 5 more minutes and I'm going to have to keep it buzzing. Why do you think I said he should stick to them YouTube vids? Because you lot don't allow me. 900 likes. I've done the shot, man. 900 likes. That's a bad boy thing. And you know what? I'm just going to continue this. I'm going to DM you a link. 2 seconds, people. I'm going to DM someone a link. I'm still here, obviously. But why stop this and then make a new? It doesn't make sense, does it, people, to stop this and then do a new stream and whatnot? I might as well just get him on very quickly. I've had him before. DM me on Twitter, bro. Can't find your app. So the quicker he DMs me, the quicker I'll get him on. He's a United fan, but he understands ball, people. He's a very positive guy. Drinking rare enough because I said as a joke that I would drink if we got to 100 likes, and them man there been running with it. It's 1,000 likes. No, but we just got to 900. Hey, man. Is where it is, man. It is where it is. I need some more honey, man. You're going to have to give me 30 seconds because the taste of redness getting buttered, but come on. You know what? Let me eat that, man. You're gassing me. Quazim, you're gassing me. Eat that. Ooh, eat that. Light work. I'm trying to find this guy's Twitter. Oh, here we go. I ate that though, man. Oh, you lot are killing me, man. You lot are bad, man. Because when I tell you lot to just click the like button, you don't want to click the like button. But when it comes to this, you want to do a mazza. You know, white rum, man. I want to allow that, man. Cut. A man said, I hope this isn't clickbait. I just joined the ladder, man. DG and quick break. Steaming by 11. You think I'm staying here to 11 with the way you lot are doing with these antics? Allow it. Hey, I wish I had one of them things there as well, man. Allow me, man. Of course I enjoyed that. It's normally Arsenal getting lenged. A man said you look like Pepe. You're buying it. Pepe, Birdry, Errol Spence. Make up your mind. Nah, not quite, but I am feeling quite up, my guy. So we might have to dead this soon still. You lot, I'm even a bit mad. Do you rate Xhaka? I like Xhaka. If it makes sense, I rate Xhaka, but not to the level that Arteta and previous managers. They know more about football than me, so I'm never going to get onto them. But at the same time, I think he's a squad player. I don't think he should be consistently playing, but I like him a lot, man. And I don't think he's as crap as people make out. Hey, Ray's bullying, man. All right, look who's back again. Big up, man. I would have liked Eze in the team, because I think we should try these championship, man, that, you know, if they don't blow, we can make our peas back. If not, it is what it is. You know, that's what went through my head. Hold that. Exactly what the olders used to say. Sorry, my... Where's Kojo gone? Where you go? Where did you go, bro? Oh, he's back. Come on. Fam, where the devil gonna be easy, fam? Glossy is touching, man. It started off at 5 and now it's touching, man. You lot should see me on a night out. You might not be subscribed to me anymore. Is where it is. I don't know about deep. If it's not a striker thing, I'm not really trying to hear that. I hear you can lose him, you can use him as a 10 and all these things. I'm not really down for that, man. But I'm acting. Let me bring my guy in, man. Sorry, wait, one thing. You need to try Appleton. Yeah, come on, bro. I got that downstairs. But listen, Ray and F is my thing. We stay together. Hey, what are you saying?
Yeah, I'm good, man. What are you saying?
I'm there, man. What, could you hear me?
Yeah.
All right, yeah. Hey, introduce yourself, man.
So Kojo from the Green Midfield podcast and Footy Dez, as well as other United podcasts if you watch United stuff. Football coach as well, so here I am.
Alright, one reason I wanted to bring you is because we'll get on to you. A man said I'm lit. Not yet. I'm holding that. A man, we're signing party, boy. So not only are you a United fan, obviously your heritage is Ghanaian. So I had to get a Ghanaian to give me the scoop. Like, and where's the jollof, bro? Like, bring that to North London. We need that. So what are you saying for party as a Ghanaian? And obviously, you obviously look out for your countrymen a lot. What are you saying for party if it does bang?
I'm annoyed because I wanted him. So the fact that we didn't look at him and you guys are about to get him is jarring. But I felt like you guys have needed someone that knows how to play the defensive midfield position to a T and he fits it perfectly. I think in terms of firm instructions, if Arteta gives him the strictest of instructions, he can do it perfectly. But on top of that, because he went for Simeone, I mean, if there's someone that is really, really structured, that's a coach that does play structured football. But on top of that, the guy can play football. He can read the game. His tackling is clean on his feet and sliding. He wins it most of the time. He tracks his runners. I know it's the era of recovery defending. He's not slow. He is quite quick. He is strong. If we're going to bring the physicality into it, he's not someone that you can just struggle for football. Decent in the air. Honestly, you guys have been looking for a DM for a while, someone that actually do the job. You signed a load of DMs.
He's passable forward as well. Like, I like this guy.
Exactly. So you've been looking for someone who can not only play, but can also do the defensive work perfectly. And I don't think you've had that for a while. And this might be the guy to do it. I think he is the guy to do it, but he has to also prove it. And I think he is the guy.
None of that previous stuff. He's Deo, man. He's Deo. Like, I can't lie. On a serious note, I think he's alone in it, in that I can't expect fireworks. You know, I think fans do this thing. You might get it with Pogba, but people expect people to be the messiah. Like, just because he's a creative man, you know, all creative issues are solved. It's not, you know, no man's the island. Partey is only going to look as good as the system. You know, he's going to shine because he's an individual player, but he needs everyone on a level. For me, I just want it confirmed because it's all fun and games, me sitting here and making me drink Ray, but it's not like we haven't got him confirmed, fam. We ain't got him confirmed. So I'm happy. You know, him and Gabriel is cool. I would have liked, maybe I'm being greedy, but 2 and 2, like another midfielder. And, you know, I would have liked to have seen Saliba play or bring in the next centre back, but I can't complain, my guy, really and truly. But what's United saying?
What are United saying? Jesus. They need Jesus.
You know what? Before we talk about you, let me write down what I'm gonna ask you. We're gonna talk about I got the pen. We're gonna talk about the transfers, bro.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna talk about Sancho.
Mm-hmm.
But first, this Spurs thing, this Spurs game. What happened, big man? What happened?
I don't know if any of your followers are aware of what I've been of what I do or what I've been saying, but for the past week, I've said to people that either United were going to scrape that game, or Spurs were going to give them a smacking. Bro, they gave them a smacking. Yeah, the smacking that that's a lie. It's not Nigerian jollof or Ghanaian jollof. Don't come and chat shit here.
They
started already. All right, cool. They started already. But when Partey comes here, you're going to do Partey time. Ghanaian. All right, I've seen it.
you got another question before you carry on, though.
It was like Kenke or Bank. Which ones do I prefer? Oh, bloody hell. I mean, the spelling's shocking, bro, but it's Kenke.
Yeah. But we
deserve that, man. It was a hiding that was coming for a while. And after the Palace game and after the Brighton game, in my head, I was like, you need one serious team to come and smack you. And Spurs were the team that was serious and they smacked them. And it's been coming. You know my feelings on the defence, especially certain captains. A name that I'm not going to say because it's banned in this house. So, you know my feelings on these guys. I've never rated them. Even Wan-Bissaka, I've been a bit 50-50 with him because I know he can defend well. But you need to offer something going forward as well. I'm not talking you have to be supreme. Just just better, decent going forward. You know, provide something extra. And he doesn't do that. So, you know, about him, I don't have to say anything about Luke Shaw, to be completely honest. I'd rather buy he got injured again. That's my opinion on him. And
no holding back.
No holding back. And Lindelof, to be honest, nah. It's just not that pretty much is the whole defense. So basically it sums up, no was it.
I've seen you lot, like this has happened against City. I've seen you lot play poor. Maybe not the scoreline, but I've seen you play poor. That was a different United for me. That's one of the worst performances, purely because one thing, like, I'm not a United fan. Like, I enjoy the banter. But in the same way that used to be with Arsenal, you win, lose, or draw, fighting together. There's a standard of doing things. I saw Sunday League antics, you know. I'm not scapegoating anyone. Pogba's doing a madness.
Oh, bro.
Wan-Bissaka's just sliding about. Shaw's just given up in this thing. Martial's obviously been conned by Lemina. Lemina should have been sent off, but he's been conned. It's just gone capitulated. Like, they're just bare individual nonsense. And that implies to me Ollie's lost them if he hasn't lost it already. Because out of respect for him, they're just doing a mazza, bro. Like, that yesterday was a mazza. Like, signings, Ollie should go, and Ollie's one thing, but that's a mazza for the players yesterday, fam.
Yeah, it is. I think the problem with United fans is this. So I'll compare it to your fans. When you guys went on that barren run of not winning any trophies, so you sort of like, as a fan base, you realised the standard had not been the same anymore. So you couldn't compete for a title, but you're still getting Champions League football. But there was an expectation to try and get better. Whereas United, in the last 7 years, even though we've been poor domestically, because we've won every trophy apart from the Premier League and the Champions League. That's the big two. That's the big two that United loved to win when Sir Alex Ferguson was about. That was the aim, the be all and the end all. You weren't talking about Europa League and all that. But because of that, United fans have tried to use that as an area to just say, yeah, we've still been successful. But for the levels you've set in the past, that's not success now.
Not success.
So if you're going to say that United are, you know, are still this and that, I'm going to be levels. I've been calling them for the last year and a half expensive Everton. And I can't lie to you, I can't even call them that now because Everton are better than us. That's facts.
Jeez.
So United are not levels.
Hey, whoa. Let me play devil's advocate. Do you feel you're being a bit reactionary? Because, I mean, when was the last time Everton, if ever, they finished ahead of you? You probably, I know Carlo's doing a mazza, but, you know, football can flip. I got to play devil's advocate here.
Because I don't know. I mean, I've been honest with you. I've been saying United have been on the free fall for a long time.
No, yeah. You've been very vocal about
that. The year that we finished second with Mourinho or winning Europa League doesn't cover anything. Those years, I will argue that we finished second, and that's when City got 100 points. And we weren't even convincing that year. So if we weren't convincing and we finished second, that says a lot about everybody else below us. Now, it's four games in. I understand that people will be like, well, you're saying that already. Everton are, you know, it's only four games, 1-4 out of 4, but they could lose the next four. I get that. But if you look at the standard of play, if you look at the structure of the team, of the club, how they are on the pitch, the coaching standards as well, and the level of talent that they're bringing in compared to us, they're better. That for me, I can, if I do a head-to-head of 11s, I could actually put some Everton players in there. I could put Lucas Digne in there. I could put Seamus Coleman in there because I don't rate any of the defenders. I could even put Yerry Mina in there. I'm not going to say Michael Keane. I think he's pants. Mm. I could definitely put
Even though Ben Godfrey ain't kicked a ball for them, I'm screaming him.
I could put Alan in there. James Rodriguez walks into every United team in the last 7 years. No questions asked. DCL has started the season like a house on fire. He's outperforming Martial very much so. Richarlison is very good. If you want to put him on the right wing, he can do that. We ain't even got a right winger. Like, do you see what I'm saying? So when I'm saying these things, people think I'm just trying to jump and be sort of like, oh, I'm upset. But these are facts. And you know me, I don't get too emotional like that. I just drop what I see. Mm. United are not the same United. And the sooner United fans deep that and recognise that they need to try and get back to that level that they used to be at, it ain't going to be the same thing. So until they realise that, that's why they keep getting bantered like that, because they go on Twitter and scream United, United, United. But you're not United anymore, bro.
That's you know what I'm saying? You know what it is with United? Like, I'm not going to say it gives me confidence like over you lot, but I'd say when you look at all of the top six, you know, Chelsea, whether their players adapt or not, they've bought players that reflect ambition. Liverpool, whether, you know, there's a case to be said, they should have brought players on to kick on, etc. They've got a good squad, one of the best squads for a while now, and they've added Thiago. You know, people can say what they want about Spurs and about Jose. They brought in about six men, you know. If they brought in a centre-half, it would have been an A-star season in the transfer market, and it already is. You know, Arsenal, Partey is one thing, if we're honest, in terms of clearing men out and bringing in everyone. It's more of the same from us. But one thing that tips us is Kalam as our squad is in the issues sort of thing. We've got Arteta, in which he might or might not be the man. At least he, right now, he shows that there's a man to at least give him a chance to walk down the tunnel to prove it. That's with right. Oli, and I'm trying to be respectful because I don't like to get at people, but you're struggling to see what he stands for. You're struggling to see system. You're struggling to see anything beyond that. We're United. We this sort of passion stuff. And that's good when you play big games. But over 38, there's an issue there.
Mm. I'll say this. Oli's football... if you see the patterns of how they start when they're in possession, it's also kind of almost kind of look like how Bayern do when they're trying to play football without the quality, because they're not on the levels of Bayern. Before anyone thinks I'm trying to say they're like Bayern, it's like they're trying to play a similar sort of style. So that's okay. The problem with Ole is this: I've always questioned his in-game management. Picking the first 11 is one thing, but then what do you do when you're in a bad situation in the game, or even if you're in a winning situation? What do you do to make sure you stay on top? Or you can change the game.
On defensive subs and conceded more goals yesterday, fam. He's on a match.
You took off Bruno Fernandes and Matic. So you took off an attacking player and you took off a defensive player. And in my head, I'm thinking, to be honest, a 4-1 down, but knowing how United fans are, how the United club has always been, it's always about attack, right? So one way or another, you're going to make attacking changes because you need to try and pull some goals back, make the scoreline more respectable. You put on Fred and McTominay. That's when I said, you know what? Your time is up, bro. Get the heck out of here. Get out. It's done. I can't defend that. There's nothing I can say. I try to be very fair with him, but that's indefensible. That's poor.
You can't defend it. Indefensible. It's simple as. You can't make up stuff and come in and cap. You can only go on what you hear as a fan. And it's that, even I'm sure many fans, like even you, like nobody wants to scream their manager out. Nobody wants to scream their manager's a bum. No one's this. I'm sure there's bare man that like to be positive and want to be that I told you so sort of thing. There's nothing wrong with not believing in a man, and Ollie goes and shows that he is the man. I'm sure no one like that more than you. Mm. But the writing's on the wall, and it's like the thing that gives me Arteta with how you feel about Ollie is how I felt about Emery. It's like, I don't know what I'm clinging on to here. Like, I don't know what I'm truly believing in. Like, I gave you a chance. I cut you a slack. You've done well in several aspects. Like, there aren't, you know, Ollie seems to be quite cool with the players. Like, they don't seem like they want to do him any wrong. But when it gets to it, man don't know what you're on. Like Jose Mourinho yesterday completely hoodwinked him and showed his experience, even with taking off Lemina. You know, several little things he showed his levels. The way he said his team should be at it from the start, it was different. It was different, man.
It was very different. This is the point. You can't defend these things. Arteta, I've looked at him, and I know you follow me on Twitter. I follow you on Twitter. So I'm sure maybe you saw my tweets when I was getting annoyed where some fans, not only Arsenal fans, but obviously fans around, were trying to mock you guys, looking at him saying he's the guy that puts down cones for Pep. And in my head, I was like, if you did your research, a lot of the attacking players that have improved at Man City are credit to Arteta. That was his coaching. It wasn't just Pep. Just because you see their All for Nothing documentary, you see Pep screaming on the touchline and that. Yes, he's the manager, so he's going to be the key man. But the staff that behind the scenes, you have to notice what they're doing. Arteta was standing out. Even when he wasn't linked with the Arsenal job, you were hearing his name about how he coaches and all that. So I was thinking, this is a gamble. Yes, of course. He hasn't got first team managerial experience.
Stevie's not there. There's no way. Like, we can't be around the bush. Like, even me, I was very optimistic about Arteta because of what he stood for. But that, until you get experience, you need to be given a chance to get experience And that is, there's nothing wrong with highlighting that. If it went wrong, we're pointing towards his management. That's the one thing for all his criticisms. Nobody's mentioning the fact that he doesn't have any real managerial experience. And I think whether he goes right or wrong here, that's testament to what he's early adopted, you know, whether, because I still have things with him that I don't think are perfect.
But do you see my problem? But notice my problem with Ole that you just said. No managerial experience. Ole has had 12 years.
Yeah. They keep putting him with Lampard and that. He's not a young G. He's not with Arteta and Lampard.
We still don't know what the hell he's trying to do. So if we can't figure it out, and he's been in the game for 12 years, whereas Arteta is now a manager for all of a couple of months, and you can see what he's trying to do, that's where the problem is. You see what I'm saying? So, you know, end of the day, I see that comment still there. The red card, I don't care about the red card because we still got panned. One way or another, they were going to get snapped. So,
I know. It's banned for him, though. Like, what do you feel about that red card? I think both men should have been sent off. Martial got caught.
Yeah, both of them should be sent off. But that's how Lamela always has been. He's always been that kind of nasty player. So, you know, me personally, if he's done something like that, I would react and say, yo, ref, have you seen that? He goes straight to VAR because you put his mind at that and say, okay, someone is out for me. Now you got VAR. It's not one of them ones where something happens, you go to the referee, he didn't see it, so you got to wait for the retrospective action. There's cameras there now, and they are asking, they're helping the referees out. So if you said, if he's something to you, just, you know, go and complain. But instead, he slapped his face. I understand that someone's elbowed you, so you're pissed off. I get it.
He's on the route to demand them thing when this guy's just played him.
Exactly. But Martial's a hothead. He's always been a hothead. I know he looks like the killer look and all that. He's always been a hothead. So when he was 2-1 down, I'm sure his head was really hot.
Hot in it, just red.
So after that, but after that, to be honest, I think even if Martial was on, bro, we looked toothless, man. We weren't going to win that game. So it is what it is.
But why do you think, though? Because I am baffled. Because for me, again, I'm no expert on VAR. But when I hear VAR, I hear, you know, for me anyways, I'm expecting it to be where there's obvious errors. For me, that's an obvious error. Like, why didn't VAR, if you know, like, since say, okay, cool, Martial should be gone. But my man is not unprovoked in this. He should go as well.
Because I feel like the referees still don't know what they're doing with VAR. You've been given VAR as a gift to help you on the pitch. And if I run it back, for example, when Eddie Nketiah got sent off, was it Eddie at the Emirates when that challenge?
That challenge, yeah.
And they went to VAR for that. That's fair. But then I remember Trent made a challenge on Alba, if I'm correct, and that wasn't looked at VAR, and that was arguably worse.
These things just make sense, man.
But they don't, they're not consistent with it, because I watch on Twitter like highlights of other countries doing it, and the best country is Australia. When there's a referee that's not sure, he goes straight to the camera himself and says, all right, cool, I'm gonna check this out myself, especially when it's to reckless fouls, because you need to see the intent. And they don't do that here. Over here, it's sort of like a referee click. Oh, the guys in the camera said it, so I believed him. I'm going to take it anyway. The guy on the pitch has made the decision. So even though we can see this on camera in the back, we ain't going to change it because we're going to back him and stand by him. No, if he's made the wrong decision, call it. There's no shame in that.
There's no shame in that.
Human, all the time. So, you know, call him out on it. But they don't do that. So, yeah, it was a red card for Lamela. It should have been. Martial should have been as well. But we got dealt with. So that red card really doesn't concern me. You know what I'm saying?
Makes sense. Yeah, no, I feel your opinion, because it's like sometimes I ain't got no examples to hand, but there's been times where Arsenal have lost, and there's, well, maybe so much under Wenger, when we, you know, when we regularly got smacked up against Chelsea, there'd be red cards, there'd be a whole heap of other incidences that would be the talking points. But I'm of the same thinking of you. It's like, here, yeah, they're factors and they might have played it, but excluding them, have you done everything you needed to get a 3 points? If you can answer that, let's focus on these mistakes. If you didn't, it's irrelevant to a degree, which I'd fully get you on that. What you say about Cavani? Because I got to ask you before you get out of Cavani and Telles, man. There seems to be happening. 33-year-old Cavani, reputation for being a gunman. You know, it's fun and games having an interchangeable front three of Rashford, Martial and Greenwood, but you need a target, man. What's your feelings on Cavani? It seems a bit.
I've wanted Cavani for years, just because I know he's a gunman. Obviously, like when you're talking about the world's best strikers, he's always been a part of that conversation, hasn't he? So I was wanting him. Now I know United fans. Actually, no, it's not just United fans, because I've seen this morning as well on Twitter that there's some Arsenal.
Anyway, one set, my guy. A man said, I'm even like Josh Kroenke. All right, cool. I'm taking a picture on that, fam. I'm going to make this guy a mod, because I can't lie. Chris, I'm sorry. You've been saying that, bear. I've been forgetting. I go on, my guy. Sorry for cutting you off.
No, no worries, man. No, the thing with Cavani is, and it's weird. United fans are getting annoyed because he's 33 years old. Mm. Now, I've seen this weird thing on Twitter. I don't know if you've seen it this morning. Partey is now, he's made moves for him. And apparently people are like, well, he's 27. Why are you going for him? I'm like,
dead.
He's not 39. Exactly. He's 27. He's prime.
Bro, 5 years, he's only 32, fam. Look at Fernandinho. Not that they're the same player. It's how you look after yourself.
Exactly.
Look at Aubameyang, different player, but come on.
Exactly. So when they criticize these things, I get annoyed. Now, the thing about Cavani is, Cavani's never been a player that needs to get involved in the gameplay, even though he does. But it's his IQ, it's his movement, it's his finishing. That's all we need. And I feel like, if you look at our options, apart from Martial, should I really be happy with Odion Ighalo? I mean, come on.
Hey, man, I've got time for Uncle, man.
I respect Uncle, innit? I respect Uncle, but it is what it is. He ain't scored. So it is what it is. He can get out.
Come on.
No, he ain't scored. He scored in the Carabao Cup last season, and I think once in the Europa League. That's about it.
Oh, yeah, that's that loan spell. That loan spell's getting done, man.
It's a disaster. And I said in my Man United group chat, that might be the worst loan deal in Man United history, and I was getting laughed at. I was like, well, go and find one worse then. And I'm still waiting to this day to find one worse.
I can rise up,
I mean. So, yeah, Cavani can come in. I don't care if he's 33 years old. It's a 2-year contract, which is fine. No, not to me, because you need another killer that can actually challenge Martial. Martial's too comfortable. And when he doesn't perform, he doesn't get dropped because Ighalo's not going to challenge him. Ighalo's here for the ride, and then he goes back in January. You need someone that's 30. You need someone that's going to get onto Martial and say, look, even though I'm 33, I still can find it back in the net in an instant. Yeah. I can find it from range. My movement is clean. I can score headers. I can score different range goals. What are you going to do? And I also think this is good for Greenwood, because you're actually near a real gunman.
You can learn Exactly.
Forget Martial FC. I don't want to hear that. You're near a real gunman, someone that will actually hit the back of the net ruthlessly from many different places, set pieces as well, decent at free kicks. He's a gunman. Bring him in all day long. I don't care if he's 33 years old.
What do you think about Dalot on loan?
If
are you not gassing him, though? I'm not gonna lie. On to United, still, you might love gassing the players, boy.
Here, I'm gonna say.
Bear man are the best ever, so you man ain't on fuck.
What I'm gonna say about Dalot is this, because I actually do like Dalot. I don't think he's been given a fair chance under Ole. Bear in mind as well, he's the one that won a penalty against PSG that kept Ole's job, but it is what it is. If this is Man United in the instant, if Timothy Fosu-Mensah, who stank at Fulham, that poor Fulham side from the time when they came last Prem, if he was poor for them, but he's still playing games, Dalot should even run away. He should ask for a permanent transfer. It's enough. Like, if that guy plays ahead of you, there's a problem there. That's what I'm going to say. Simple as that.
Shit, man. All right, before I let you get out of here, because I know time's of the essence, there's a few hours left in the transfer market. What are you hoping for?
I'm not going to lie to you, bro. My hope was gone a long time ago, because you've gone from trying to get Sancho to Ousmane Dembele to Amad Traoré. And that's no disrespect to Amad Traoré. He's 18 years old. He's a kid. So there's no hate on him. But it doesn't make sense to try and go for two players that are potential game changers to someone that you're going to hope reaches his potential. But we need to get Telles. Oh, Telles is almost done anyway. So Telles.
What's your feelings on that quickly as well, man? Telles, you know, left back. I don't know is that an area United fans are looking at? Did they make sure? I know Brendan Rodgers has been doing a thing there. I'm not sure.
Yeah, Telles, we've wanted the left back for a while. It's no secret that United fans have not been happy with Luke Shaw for a while. So with Telles, if United fans are thinking that he's going to be defensively better than Shaw, he's like that much defensively better. It's not a big difference, but offensively, he's so clear. All you got to do is check his assist record. You got to see some videos of him and his decision making and how he. how he finds his targets in the box. You know, his crossing is very good. His reading of the game is very well. He gets great runs. So it's much more efficient. And he scores, I mean, he scores penalties, but he's got a decent goal scoring record. So coming to United, that's all we know, winning penalties. So that would be a dream for him. So, I'm happy with that signing. That's one that was desperately needed, as was Cavani, in my opinion. I don't know how United fans feel about that, but that's necessary.
Last question before I get out of here, before I let you get out of here. Yeah. What's your feelings on the top four, like top four shouts?
Funny enough, I feel like Spurs are going to make it.
Same.
Yeah, I think if you do confirm Partey, you have a chance. I know, hear me out. I know you're not convinced, but if you sign Partey,
you're my guy, but no.
Yeah, no, just hear me out. If you do sign Partey, that is a big, big step up in quality of what you need in that midfield.
Oh, for sure, for sure.
And if he settles in quickly and you start to get a run of results, I feel like you'll be a lot more comfortable in that race. But if not, obviously City and Liverpool are going to be there. I don't like saying that, but it is what it is. Spurs, and I don't really think it's going to be us. I generally think it's between you, Everton, and possibly not even Leicester. No, just you two. I don't count United in this. I don't think
You think Everton are in it, but not Leicester. That's an interesting one.
No, because you can't. They're too inconsistent for me. You can't be beating City like that and then get absolutely destroyed by West Ham like that. And West Ham are going to go on to lose the next 6-7 games anyway. You know how they are. So I don't trust their consistency and the way they fell off towards the end of last season to finish in the Europa League spots. That's why I question them. I do want to say us, but if I'm being honest, with Ole at the managerial helm, I don't think it's happening.
You kill me, man. I'm definitely going to have you on here more to chat, man. But hey, listen, for people that don't know you, I mean, you've been getting a lot of love in the chats. And, you know, I know you bring out a lot of content, but for people that haven't listened and not aware, man, talk your stuff, man. Let them know.
I'm pretty much everywhere these days. Okay, let's see. So I know this is Deluded's page. So it's an Arsenal fan base here.
Love your stuff. It don't matter about that.
I'm on two United channels. One's called All for United, where we just, you know, bitch and moan about United because that's all we can do right now. And another one called Usman Talks United. That's my boy who let me go onto his channel. But we get fans from every club to come and talk football. So that's perfect. My stuff, Footy Says, of course, we interview footballers, coaches, journalists, and free midfield, as in the football analysis of games, interviews here and there. With Deluded's been on there before, which we need to get sorted out.
Yeah, need to find that again.
And yeah, we just talk a lot of football. We're everywhere, so come give us a follow and chat football all the time. We're always there, man. So always welcome.
Definitely hit them up, people. I want to see Kojo's things go up by a bit more subscribers, people. Open up another tab and hit that up, man. Hey, send me all the details, and I'll put them in this description, bro. But love to you, my guy.
I love, bro. Appreciate it.
Take care of yourself, my dude.
You too. Have a good one, guys.
Don't know. So now, people, obviously, he's had to keep it moving. We're just waiting on Turkish, boy. Hey, go and hit up Turkish's tick. Hey, what? Hey, people. Hey, shall we call Turkish? Hey, fuck it. Let's call Turkish. Let's call Turkish. You know what? Hey, Turkish, I see you in the comments, bro. And I WhatsApp you. Let's call Turkish, people. Let's call. Other guys can have all the graphics and that, but they're not levels like, man, bro. Who else is going to do this? Oh, Turkish ain't going to pick up. You know what they say? If they don't answer the phone for you, don't care about you, man. He's probably busy and man's calling that. Hey, Turkish. Hey, let me say where you at, man. Where you at? The people are waiting. You ain't seen Fried yet, my G. Hey, Quasi. Chill out. I did it. Chill out, man. Come on. I have. Ah, he said he's on the phone. Calm, bro. I can't lie. I just tried to call you live on air. The fans, them are waiting for you, man. Come, man. Ooh, my phone died, people. Ooh. Let's wait one sec, people. One sec. Man said, Hayes. Allow that, man. You lot have to get him. I don't think he fucks with man still. He used to be cool, though. I got nothing but love for that guy, even though he sends for man on Twitter and that. DJ is on it, bro. Guest drink. Fam, we do this thing, fam. I told you. Them man there can have all the, you know, I'll get my charger, people. One sec. Them man there can have all the fancy graphics and all them. And we're going to get, oh, shit. We're going to get that one day. But until then, it's a myth, people. Can't lie to you lot. Something just almost dropped to me and almost collapsed me, people. The light. And the light's actually gone out, as you lot could see. I'm just destroying my set. I apologize, people. We're back now. We're going to wait for Turkish and then we're going to keep it moving because I got to be somewhere still, people. I'm not even going to lie. See, I just mashed up the screen and everything, just calammed it all. But yeah, I needed to get my charger. My phone died, people. See what I do for you? Like, I let my phone die. We've been here for almost 2 hours. A leany, people. I was only trying to be here for an hour. Aye, man, that guy Hollywood, man. I'll be trying to get troops all the time, man. He's a difficult guy to get hold of, but love troops, man. 80k a week. I'll do the gunner show. It's be a bit short, but it is what it is. I'm the best to drink with, man. You lot just think I'm some boring you. You just talks about footy, innit? Like, you lot kill me, man. Nah, you lot need to rate me. Not at all. Aye, it's touching me, Jon Snow, but we getting there, man. Queffin, nothing, man. We just, you lot made me drink them raise shots. I don't want another 100 people watching this car. I'm not in it no more. Like, a man said prank call. Come on, man. Patting up, man. Man said prank call. Right, anyways, back to the football, people. No more football questions. What's going on in the market? What's going on? Make sure you're hitting the like button. Not too much, because I don't want to do this again. But, like, nah, rate, man. We're not fried yet. Nah, dead, man. I ain't drinking no water. Dead all of that, bro. I can't even pre-transfer news for you. Look, someone bring some transfer news, man. Someone bring some transfer news. Low tech, but the best vibes, man. It's as simple as that. Like, you know how it is, man. There's talent in the hood. You think if Sky Sports didn't give me a mad thing, we'll be doing a mazza? I'm the best at this, man. Let me stop being humble, man. Dead the humble thing. You know, if Turkish don't hurry up, then we're going to keep it moving, man. Because I ain't got nothing else to say to you lot, fam. Do you watch F1 if you do shows on F1? Nah, if it's on, I'll keep it on. But I ain't really an F1 fan. Shout out to Hamilton. When Hamilton keeps it moving, I'm going to bust out still. Swear down. No, but Jeffrey Adley's one was off for a minute still. So I don't think that one there is any new. Well, it looks like he'll be staying and we'll probably move him on between January and next year because he'll have a year to run on his contract, Kalajinax, next year. Ha ha. Hey, big up you. Big up you. Only real ones will get what he's talking about. Big up you. So a man used to work, and then I used to work in Camden, and then I left. But yeah, for the real G's who remember that one when we used to be in Camden Square, Soho Square, it used to be crazy, man. Yeah, he's gassing, man. He's gassing. He went on 80k a week, man. He's gassing. All right, we're going to have to leave. We're going to have to leave Turkish, because Turkish taking kind of long still, and the charger's not charging, so I don't know what. I'm not of the level to take Edu's job just yet. Maybe one day I'll be able to do such, my guy. We keep working. He seems to be done. It seems that we'll see official confirmation when they see a player leave. Ironically, maybe that will be Partey. When Partey's busts out, maybe they can confirm the signing of Partey. I love your content from Kenya, bro. Big up my Kenyan people then, man. What's the saying you lot say? My friend's Kenyan. He says, I wish I had it. You remember them pigeons, man. Them lunch breaks were shay. Them lunch breaks were tiresome. Yeah, them, you had the nitties, you know. Just trying to make videos. I want to get to 30k, man. It feels like I can't grow on them thing there, man. But we keep pushing, man. We keep pushing. Hit the like and subscribe button and the rest of it. You missing them pigeons? Yeah, in a funny way, man. The newest popcorn album. If you're talking the one I think you are, I'm not going to lie. It's meaty still, brother. It's meaty still. It's not really a certain thing. It's meaty. Mad meaty, but it is what it is. My guy. Swear down. I need to type that in, man. I need to type that in. Bro, what transfers? I've been talking about transfers. I'm waiting for thingy. Come on. Nah, what they do? If it ain't nothing to do with the dude, I don't care. I big up my guy, Sonny, man. We need you on this channel very soon, my dude, man. I ain't forgotten you. You need to tell me when you're free and available. We need you on this channel still. Make sure you're all following his thing and shouting at his thing and on his channel and that. He's got some good opinions. Not going to lie, if you want the filtered and diplomatic thing, he's not the guy to be going to. Thank you. Trust me, man. Thanks for the praise, my guy, man. Love, my guy. So the Kolasinac deal is off. If the Kolasinac deal is off, then it's not. It's more of the same, you know. I expected Kolasinac to stay. I did think he'd someone we tried to move on, but he's clearly not. He's not. It wasn't going to happen. And at least we've got left back cover for this season. To be fair, he's been used in a back three. I'm sure Arteta has some use for him. In an ideal world, you know, we could move him on, but it is what it is. We'll have to review his situation. You know, we'd have to review his situation come the end of the season because he'd have a year left to run on the deal. But we'll have to see. Now, you need to get that back, man. Fuck all that giving up stuff, man. Get it back, Sonny, man. We need you. Pattern up. Love, Daniel. At least I could provide some content. Slavery post, mad. I wish I shared your positivity, my dude. I wish I did. I'm going to quickly check Twitter and, I'm going to have to leave Turkish, man. I don't think Turkish is coming through still. I'm going to have to go still. Let me look one more sec. You said give him 5-10 minutes max. So 10 minutes will be 3 minutes, folks. So we're going to have to do that. I'm on Julio Ronz's Twitter, people, and he hasn't tweeted. Let me go and see some general Arsenal news. I can actually go back on my phone, which means I can stay here with you guys. We're down to 900 people are busting out. Let's go and see what happened, man. Let's go and check if there's any transfer news and whatnot. According to Kicker, Siad Kolasinac will not be joining Bayer Leverkusen today. Marca say Atletico insists they do not have any knowledge of Arsenal's intention to pay Thomas Partey's release clause. As you lot know, we're apparently in talks to sign Malmo's 6'4" striker Nicolas Dos Mola, who's going to be a physical handful. Daniel Ballard has gone out on loan, like I've said, people, to Blackpool this time. He said, "I'm over the moon to really get excited. I'm over the moon to be here, and I'm really excited to get here. It's a great opportunity to play for a club like Blackpool, and I'm really determined to play. And the 21-year-old needs minutes." Hey, man, in terms of professionalism, I guess for you lot, I'm prepared to do that. But I mean, if you remember the whole saga a few months ago, I ain't finna do all that integrity over everything. Guillaume Balaguer said, Athletic don't know anything about Arsenal's paying Thomas Partey's buyout clause. They, of course, do not need to know as it's done directly with La Liga. But after talking regularly about to Lucas Torreira, they expect a courteous call that has not arrived yet. So, hey, fuck what you lot think, man. Hey, Atletico, fuck all of that, man. Why do we need to give you nothing? All summer, you didn't want to give Partey a Donny. You didn't want to give us Partey. You wanted to make it hard for us. You played around with Torreira, but we owe you a courtesy call. We owe you nothing. You didn't want to give us Partey. We owe you nothing. What courteous call? For what? You lot wanted to buy Torreira, so you bought him. We don't owe you nothing. Forget all of that. What kind of nonsense is that from Atletico? It's done directly with La Liga. We're paying the release clause. It is what it is in that regards, man. Come on. If we're getting Lamar, I don't mind that, my guy. I don't mind bringing in Thomas Lamar, but it is what it is. Nick Ames, 82, of The Guardian, has said, according to him, Hertha Berlin are understood to have paid a loan fee for Guendouzi, but there is no obligation to buy. Apparently, Thomas Partey will sign a 4-year deal worth 250k a week and a 7-figure signing on fee, which, again, at his age, is important to remember, people. To be fair, I don't mind that because he's signing a 4-year deal. He'll be 31 and then we'll probably try and do a 1-year extension or whatever. That's still a long time. Yeah, according to Telefont, Saint Etienne are pushing to sign William Saliba back on loan from Arsenal. I don't mind that. Again, there's instance in that. Apparently, James Ollie said Arsenal inquired about Jorginho, but Chelsea didn't want to strengthen a rival. Arsenal had scouted Danilo Pereira, but opted not to follow up that interest. That chain of events meant they circled back to a decision on whether to trigger Thomas Partey's release clause. Sources have told ESPN that Arsenal now have shown a willingness to pay the 45 million fee, personal terms are set to be discussed and a medical is likely to take part in Spain. Big up AFC Bell once more time for being very much on this story all summer. Apparently, according to El Chiringuito TV, which I cannot pronounce, Thomas Partey has informed Atletico of his wish to join Arsenal. And yeah, the league, Arsenal's legal team are now working at London Coley to get this deal done, really, people. Apparently, according to David Ornstein, preparations are being made for Thomas Partey's medical to be undertaken in Madrid. Arsenal are already aware of the personal terms he would demand. So again, it shouldn't be much of a problem. Big up deluded. Always in his feelings. Forget them, man. No, to be fair, you know, a contract worth 250,000 is acceptable. No, they're not paying him that. They're not paying him that. Nobody said that. Nobody. Let me scroll. You lot are making me scroll right back up. He's signing a four-year deal around 250,000. That's how much it's worth. That's not his weekly thing. Please, everybody, listen. And again, he'll probably sign a hefty signing on fee, which I don't mind, people, to be fair with you, because at the same time, you know, he's expected that. 27, that's a good deal. And I don't know if Atletico were going to give him that. Do you lot agree with Saliba going back on loan to St. Etienne? I'm not too sure. I don't mind Jorginho, but that one day is not going to happen. Apparently, Fulham still remain keen on a loan move for William Saliba, although, of course, they face competition for such. Trying to find if there's... It doesn't seem to be anything. It appears that it's going to be one and done. Sorry, Sonny. If I speak, it's a madness. He will probably get a hike, man. His 40k will probably go up to 80, maybe 100. He'll sign a four-year deal worth £250,000 over 4 years, and he'll get a signing on fee. So it's acceptable. It's expected. Like my man said, he'll probably get around that, maybe a bit more, maybe a bit less. Maybe, man. Maybe, but I don't think he's gone. You're right. He does need game time. Bro, I don't mind Jorginho. Like, I don't think he's going to make a difference, but I'm not... What I mean by that is a bit like Willian. I'm not going to cry if he signs for this club and start shouting and carry on a certain sort of way. That's exactly what I mean. Apparently, Socrates to Roma, people. Apparently, Socrates of Roma is now a concrete option in these final hours. A member of the entourage of the Greek defender confirmed to AS Roma Press, which would be a good deal as we get the 32-year-old off the wage books and free up stuff. And for me, every centre-half that leaves between now and deadline day makes it more likely William Saliba stays at Arsenal. Elsewhere, Hertha Berlin are playing coy on Twitter in relation to a deadline day signing and kind of egging it on. Make sure you smash and like, people. It's as simple as that. So we're going to have to see. It seems that there's nothing more apart from the Saliba on loan. I mean, Saliba going on loan and Partey coming in. And apparently, according to Marca, Atletico losing Partey is an absolute shock to Simeone and one of the bombs of the last deadline day. And you've got Torreira, it's not that deep, man. Apparently, Alberto Montero TV on Pereira said, Arsenal are going to pay that clause. Once you pay the clause, the player is yours. Arsenal have already called La Liga to confirm. So again, it's a case of us, or Partey is fully ours. So let's get him in. And for me, there's everything to include. He's going to be good, man. You know, he's going to be, you know, he speaks Spanish, which is of you know, can help playing with Aubameyang, can help with a lot of stuff, helps with Arteta. Obviously, he's been in defensive systems, so three at the back won't mean much to him. He's aggressive. He's strong. He's going to be a star, man. You know what, my guy? In the grand scheme of things, is 27 million really, really, really a waste of money right now? I get it, but at the same time, I don't think it is. I get it because, you know, we've kept him there on loan. We've not kept him, you know, this season, allegedly. But if he's not of the level, what I'm not saying you, Sonny, but what are teammates, what are players going to say, what are fans going to say when he's evidently getting exposed? I think Arteta's taking a look at him and he don't currently think he's ready. I understand him going back on loan to France, but I would like the Premier League loan. I don't think there's much new news, people, in relation to anything. But what I am going to, yeah, I mean, Turkish isn't here. So I'm going to wrap this up for you. I'll probably be back later, but it is what it is. Please make sure you like, comment and subscribe. It's been a fantastic 2 hours with you guys. We've been running it up. It's really been fantastic. Like I said, man, it's been an appreciative one. big up to everybody that's tuned in. We was touching almost 2,000 at one point. So it is what it is. People, DG.